Zirka is from a family with a strong masculine father, pure feminine mother, a twin brother and an older brother.
How'd you know that?
10/10 genetics, 6 feet 5 inches, olive skin, European, beautiful face, and still...
Thank you. Yeah, I swear to God, only... When I stop trolling because people are like, I like your motivational shit, I love your trolling, but I needed to hear that. And I'm, you know, I get that hero complex. I'm like, oh, I'm saving people. And, you know, I start going harder on that. And then I started thinking to myself, I'm an idiot for thinking my family is common. I guarantee you 90% of chatters had shit families. That's why I feel a responsibility. Like, you know, I talked to my brother, Mr. Therapy Guy, and he said, well, what's the other side of the outlaw? You love the chaos, but what's the other side? The ideal self. I'm like, I'm a hero. And he said, don't you feel weird when you make just content about trolling? If you're getting thousands of emails saying you saved me? I'm like, yeah, but, you know, I saved these thousands. They're with Christ. They're cool. I did that with the Holy Spirit, you know. And he said, yeah, but why go back to it? I'm like, I'm a funny guy. And he's like, oh, you're done saving? And that really fucked me up. When he said that on in our private server on the call, I said, I'm not done saving. It's just a little break. And he said, no, dude, you take breaks from being Batman and there's people out there trying to kill themselves watching your content. I'm like, they watch everything. They don't just watch me. And he said, you know, you're too old to be dominated by the trickster. You know, and I need, in my head, I'm like, I need breaks. I want to do some troll content, but I'm really changing gears because not only is it paying a lot more, I never realized I'm the father archetype to a lot of chatters. But if you have a platform, whether girl or guy, you're playing mommy or daddy. That's what you're doing. And I'm tired of being a bad dad, half dad. You know, it's like an age, that's Saturn law and order, you know, like. Yeah, and I glow a lot more when I'm like, you know, I tell chat to do something and then I show you guys the opposite, what I'm doing, and then you guys don't, you know, you guys don't do it. But if I'm doing the right thing and then you guys go, oh man, this guy gets bitches doing the right thing, I want that life, that's a better magnet, that's the official magnet, right? But yeah. But now again, I'll always be fighting that chaos. Like if I would be such a faggot if I said, you're not gonna see me like that. Yeah, you are. Because if you're ruled by an archetype, it's inevitable. Could be in a year, could be in a month, could be, yeah. But this is the first time in my life where my paycheck went up and I didn't sabotage. I don't sabotage the paycheck, but I sabotage the work ethic in trade for chaos. And this is the first time where I'm like, nah, dude, order is, I hate to say it, but I don't love order like I love chaos, but I love it on you guys. That fills me, dude. Like, the gayest quote ever is, life starts, no, I'm just making this quote up, but this is how I think these corny quotes go. One, if you're listening. Life starts when you start doing things for other people only. Not sometimes, only. That's your career. And I'm like, I can't believe how much time I spent trolling, dude.
Rabbi_Shmuley donated horrible. $5. Advice for 6 life paths in life, but especially in career.
6. Usually they have good family restaurants, but if you do business with your family or something close, it's not that bad. But 6 is a very introverted number, you know? So... I always say, if you're not balancing your opposite, your unconscious is going to build up and it's going to snap. So let's say you're an introvert, and if you're not being extroverted at will, holy fuck, are you in for a rude awakening. So you got to play opposites. You think I want to go on the Raj show and stay with, like, you know, they're good people, but not for me. But I did it because balancing that opposite gave me a new door. And you'd be a retard if you didn't do that in my shoes. Like, what are you gonna just... There was a time where I was like, okay, I'll stream drug deal and go to the club once a week, twice a week, just to keep network. And yeah, even a year after, I said, God will punish me if I just deal drugs. I did it one more time a year after with...
Yeah. Five Cock Jackson donated $5. What's the best way to isolate yourself from people who bring distractions when you're trying to focus on yourself?
That's the thing, dude. It's never people. If you're ever trying to change people, you've lost. You're not God, dude. You have to change the inner. That's what prayer is. God, give me the strength to work 12 hours a day so I become that millionaire that I know I'm becoming. You don't say, God, give me $1 million. That sounds like a devil contract to me, right? Like, and the devil will screw you over on that one. You get fucked in the ass by Diddy and get a 360 deal out that, you know? Like, God has never, hey, give me a Ferrari and he sends you a Ferrari. No, he'll send you the mindset that gets the Ferrari. That's why the Ferrari feels like, wow, this is fun. Because you got it yourself. And I say yourself because if I say God did it, which God does everything, which literally means don't talk about it, right? But yeah, there's a longing you have to be with your higher self because it's floating up there with God. It's like an after image, and it's a mold that you have to fill in with yourself. Kind of like the anima. Like every girl you date will try and fit this mold of your perfect woman, the anima. And when she's not fitting it, like your perfect woman doesn't swear and she starts swearing, you start arguing with her because she's not fitting your perfect mold, even if she's a good girl. And if you have an issue with that anima, because the anima is built from all experiences you have with sister, mom, girlfriends, all females fit that angelic archetype of like female. And women have that too. They have the animus. That's why they're so into me. They're like, man, that guy yelled at me. He's such a fatherly animus. He fits the mold of like a man. You know, and there people are desperate for that mold. Like you are desperate. Like the mold I want you guys to focus on is your higher self. You need to actually, if you have a picture in your head of you wearing some nice blue jeans coming out of a Ferrari, go buy those nice blue jeans. You're halfway there. And then steal the energy in your head that you have when you have the Ferrari. And that energy is smiling, working, networking, extroverted. That's the guy you have to be. Right? Yeah. And that mold is for everything. People are like, well, what moments of my life should I not focus on the mold? Stupid. Every second should have that mold in your head. When I buy a coffee, I go, be extra polite. Be extra polite to this bitch, because that's the higher me.
I am Ryan Price donated $5. Birthday September 19th, 1999. Life path 11. Making a living doing short form content but expanding to YouTube. Any advice?
Advice, I'd say number one is always if you have friends in the game, you go up faster. But number one is value. Bring value, it'll go viral.
Born on August 24th, 2004. Hitting 11 life path.
Oh, we're not
doing this. Can I make it in life money wise?
It doesn't matter.
You're lost right now.
It doesn't matter. You have an 11, so you're going to make. Your problem is going to be how to control your emotions. Because you're going to make it and still be a little bitch.
Don donated $5. Advice for a guy who grew up without his father trying to find my place in life at 19. Dad died when I was a kid and my brother got locked up for life when I was 7. Just been me and my mom.
You got to grow up, bro.
Jordani donated
You're the dad $5. Now. I'm the dad. We're all the dad.
Believe the genetics.
You're 16. You're the dad.
The family we're born into is random. Ugly, short people with bad parents had to have done something to anger God. Beauty and strength are the pillars of God.
Well, in Egyptian secret texts, it says that certain planetary alignments are healthy for kids, and you have to save up the energy. You can't just be piping your wife all the time. And everyone does babies wrong. That's why everyone's different heights and different symmetry and. But good-looking babies came out on good alignments that you're supposed to. Like, that's what chanting is. Is panting when you're piping and, you know, you're trying to make a healthy baby. That's like a... Like, piping someone is a form of magic if you're going to bring a soul onto Earth. Yeah, and your karma got to be clean. So, yeah, 99% of people born on Earth are born on the wrong alignments. That's why they're ugly, right? That's according to Hermetic text. I don't know. You know, I'm not God. Jesus told us occultism is satanic. Occult means hidden. right? That's all it means. So yeah, there's a lot of hidden stuff that's satanic, but there's a reason why he spoke in parables. There's also stuff that's hidden there for higher level, higher minds. Are you and Reyna having a fling? I don't have flings with chicks, bro. Unless it's like for content, bro, but I don't do that. What the fuck? You're either my, like, what's that called? You have to be my girlfriend for like 3 weeks, and then we'll see what happens. You can't just be a fling. That means like I'm sharing you? What the fuck? No, I need your passwords. What the hell? Yeah, Paul, Paul. Genuinely, this is what I think about Christianity. If there's any bitterness to being a Christian, you're not a Christian. Like, there's nothing bitter about going to Christ. You know?
Eve Book donated $5. So, yeah. Our Father who art in heaven, God is the cock and heaven is the pussy.
What the fuck? Okay. Yeah, anyways, what was I saying? Fuck. Yeah, I was saying some good stuff there. There's definitely stuff you should run with, because this angelic being that, you know, we pervert these angelic kind of sun rays from God. This angelic being is being perverted by Mike. And, you know, you want freedom, and then it turns to liberation. And liberation from what? From order. This angelic kind of archetypal phenomena that's in all of our brains is pushing Mike to do stupid shit, and he has to unpack it, you know? And usually people have to, like, yeah, a lot of it gets unpacked at rock bottom, but the problem is when you're an entertainer, there is no rock bottom, because it's always going to boost your career, which is your identity. A part of it is your persona, how you reconcile with the world, like just the mask you put on for the world. And not to say that he's fake, like everyone is fake. Like, you guys don't know what color underwear I'm wearing. That's a persona, right? If you guys knew everything about me, then that's the real me. But I'm wearing pink. But yeah, that's what I mean by everyone. Like, I have a thin persona, so it's fun to watch me. But my persona to myself is very thick, you know? Like, I don't like to be reminded of my whole self, because my whole self is very, like, when I'm live and awake and conscious, I feel very, oh yeah, you know, Jesus gang. But I know the other parts of me, well, I don't know it, they're always going to be behind me, but you guys can sense that. And, you know, I have to unravel that slowly. And some people, like Goggins, will dominate their unconscious, and that's, they'll tell you, you can change anything. And yeah, you can change anything. The issue is you don't want to. You like these patterns. So you got to make the patterns healthy.
Samuel Don 888 donated $5. Life Path 20 has own a small casino / game room. Any suggestions for life?
You're not a 20, bro. 20 is hidden 11. And we know what we say about that. Worst street fight experience. What is this, cock measuring time? Bro, we're not doing that, bro. What is that like? Yeah, I've never bled too much like this, but I have been, my head's been double the size it's been. I've been jumped. I deserved it.
Joe donated $5. You say praying is a good thing, which I agree, but why does Gary think it's demonic?
Fuck this Gary. No, Gary knows better than Zerka's Jesus.
Underwear donated $5.30. Drop merch, but some decent design shirts that people would wear. Also, 8LP and born on
23. Some Jesus King merch. Advice. Advice: don't leave your house, bro. Yeah. Anyways, I'm gonna wrap it up soon. But what were we talking about? Yeah, basically, Mike's shadow is unraveling before our eyes. And a lot of the shadow traits are also good, so he'll identify with the good ones. But the ones that are pulling him to get stabbed, he needs to address. He needs to actually talk to his higher self and be like, Hey, man, the higher self is a projection where you go, oh, wow, you're living a great life and not in pain, and you're close to God, and you're at peace. You're not happy, you're at peace. That's the ultimate bliss. And you never ask that higher self, how do I get there? Because, like, you're seeing how you get there. Yeah, everyone knows how. But you're looking at him like, are you real? And he don't wave, he don't smile, he makes the same face you do. So if he's disappointed in you, you're disappointing yourself. You need to go back to that, bro. That you with wings, you have to go to that mic. Yeah, tell him to stop taking mollies. Well, he doesn't do drugs. All he does is his prescription Adderall and the alcohol, which is a potent mix, amphetamine with depressant. That's the fight mix. Like everyone who does, or let's say coke. If someone's doing coke and alcohol, that's a fight mix. Even you don't even have to be a fighter to fight on that stuff. That's yeah. Only thing worse would, yeah. We're not talking about this shit, bro. Like, what the fuck? Because at the end of the day, it's the drugs and stuff like that is they're superchargers, right? Someone said, why does the higher self sound boring? Dude, the higher self is in a Ferrari with a hot babe and he's calm. He's not jittery like you when you get a 4 out of 10. Like, how the fuck is that boring? The higher self is when you've had good dates and you were like, she thought you were whole, so you felt whole, like you got your life together. What are you talking about? You should be in love with your higher self, right? Because all you do all day is talk to your lower self, your animal nature, your desire nature. And you trust me, you want to be at my point where I brag about how much money I make, but I don't need it, right? I just want more. I will have more, excuse me. I already have more. It's coming. Like, let me correct that. Now, bro, Mike been taking Molly since Texas. No, he hasn't. You can tell who's on Molly. Like, that's not, what are you talking about? Yeah, bro. If you drank alcohol with that much alcohol with Molly, you know how much you'd be puking. Like, are you fucking retarded? You should bring Sneeko to Kosfo, and I mean, yeah, he's invited. This is gonna be my hometown buddies, and I think Mike's coming. He better come if he's doing this kind of shit. Eric DeBay's views on Jesus. I don't give a fuck about anyone's views if they don't believe in Jesus. Like, bro, I'll listen to you teaching me how to shoot a basketball, but if you say you don't believe in Jesus, I'll never take you serious on religion. Like, that's, because I'm not the kind of guy who's like, yeah, go Jesus. I tried it. It worked. And I've stayed around people who tried it and it worked for them. And then I have 180,000 Christians who had worked for them in the comment section. Like, yeah, we're not experimenting with your fucking retard ways. The fuck? Yeah. Jesus is the world's soul. Oh, shit, Mike's calling.
I hear good news.
Mike,
I got to tell you all this $5. That we just What's the difference
We're live,
between
yeah.
praying and meditating? One, text me your email. Sagan's going to send you the VOD so you can have it early. So you can react to the whole thing. So
it's 40 minutes. But it's like right before the fight.
I mean, I don't. Wait, why is that? I don't got to do that. I already saw Diddy was wanting it to happen.
Yeah. Well, but yeah. No injuries. No orbital break. No bad vision. Nothing
yeah,
wrong
it's
with
the
my
cut
eye.
Under the eye. Needed.
No, yeah, it's good. They can't really stitch it up, so I just have to make sure I'm on top
No,
of it.
but no, none of the white got hit. Yeah.
Yeah. None of it. Yeah.
Yeah. That because
well,
that
definitely
looked.
The whites got hit. You know that guy's been arrested. That guy got arrested a year ago for assault.
Oh shit!
We have his mugshot and everything. Yeah.
Oh.
You also want to hear something crazy?
He's going to jail.
I have this Backstreet Boys outfit. It's gonna be crazy. You're gonna like this, and so are your community. And he can back me up. It's not even talk. I'm in this white ass outfit, and we're trying to leave. I go, a red tie would look so funny. It would look like so 2005. A loose red tie.
Yo, why? Wait.
A red tie.
You. This is
wait,
the
you have
worst
to hear this.
outfit
a red
for
tie.
blood.
You have
He's
a red
like.
tie. Listen, you have to hear this. Oh yeah.
Look at the outfit, bro. This looks retarded.
I'm gonna return these clothes tomorrow. I bought them today. I'm like, can you take these back? They don't fit me. Yeah.
No, you should keep them.
Yeah, I'm wearing them tomorrow on stream if I get on banned.
Mike, bro, dude.
I'm gonna be safe. I got it. But you gotta hear this. So I'm looking everywhere for a red tie. This isn't bullshit. Everywhere I go, I can't find a red tie. All the stores are closed. I go, whatever, a red tie would have been good. Damn it. A random lady who's at the mall alone when we're waiting for Uber goes, red tie. She goes, you need red on you tonight. The demons will get you if the red. I swear to God, you have to defend me on this.
No, it's true. It's true. Some random old lady.
Old lady who was at the mall alone goes, you get red. It keeps the demons away. Red's your lucky color. Get some, wear something red with that.
That's so weird.
And she goes, I'll do readings for you. I was like, dude. I was like, well, and I didn't get the red tie, and then I finally got the licking.
What?
Swear, wait, why did God on my family?
How come you didn't? How come you didn't get in the Uber?
I tried to. The Uber driver came out. Did you see that?
What?
You see everything.
Dude, he chased me down to the Uber. I opened the door, yeah, and he was like, and he was banging on the Uber's door. Uber, like the Uber driver goes, whoa, what are you guys doing? Got him a
ticket. Oh, what the fuck?
And they pushed the Uber driver out the way. Oh, me and the Uber driver had to talk to police. They pushed the Uber driver out the way. And we circle the car four times. I go, bro, there's 10 of you. Like, he's like, it's a one-on-one. I go, you guys are all friends. You guys are all friends. Like, what? It's a one-on-one. I go, one, you guys are black and it's dark out. I can't see. It's like not even a fair. It's not even a fair fight. Like,
yeah, black people hate white people.
Dude, and I'm like spinning around the car. I'm like, I don't want to fight. I don't want to fight. I'm drunk because I was hammered. I was hammered.
Yeah.
And dude, it's crazy. That's why I'm still spam messaging Eddie. I was like, you got to post a pod. I go, these guys followed me to the car, pushed the Uber driver. The Uber driver's like, what's going on?
Honestly, bro, that VOD should be on your YouTube channel if you're going to post it.
Yeah, I'm posting the full VOD to the YouTube channel.
I told you he's good. Look at him. He's a scientist. You want to see what he also got? Look at this. Mr. Nightcrawler. Look how sexy these are.
Yeah, that actually looks really good. Oh, wow. That's really good.
Right?
What the hell? Why do you look better there? What the fuck? That looks really good.
My fit was fire today. You should have saw my fit. I wore a completely sideways white hat too.
That's the gayest shit I've ever heard, bro. No, I did that. I did the same thing. I had a visor where my hair comes out, and I wore it upside down, sideways.
I'll call you back.
Wait. Can I talk to the nurse real quick?
No.
Tell her I want to shoot a load. Let me shoot a load. She's fucking. The second nurse is fine as shit. Yeah, she would if she saw me, dude, she would. You know, I've never had a nurse that didn't try me.
Pipe Cock donated $5. Difference between praying and meditating, and is meditating satanic?
No, intention satanic, but meditation opens you up to thinking. Like, there's two types of meditation: mindfulness. It's more imaginative and active, and emptying your mind. Emptying your mind is good for those guys who want to get possessed, or it's good for lowering anxiety. But I've always meditated by releasing everything about my world, my inner world, my real world, my superficial world, and then filling it with God. So I've never meditated without God. I don't really get the Eastern thing, you know? I think a relationship with your coach gets you further in life than having no coach and doing it yourself. But 90% of the time, I do have the psyche that I am God. Not that I am God, like the creator and stuff like that, but he wants me to say I am. I can do it myself. I am a millionaire. The blessings are just the wheels, right? Or excuse me, the fuel, right? But yeah, like I act alone in my action. But in my faith, I've never been alone since I became a Christian last year. So I've never, haven't been, well, there's days where I'm alone and I'm sure you know which days, like you can see it. But I always come back because, you know, we are of the flesh. We slip a lot. Yeah. I mean, how many times do you guys fall off the God's horse, God's white horse? I fall off God's white horse and fall on some fucking Latino white, you know? 3 times a day, no cap? That's low. What the fuck? There's way higher than that. Yeah, mindfulness is a good way to put it. I use symbols when I meditate. So, you know, symbols that mean a lot to me. Usually it's not symbols that I'll create. It's like, you know, there's always a symbol that'll remind you of your dad. So it'll trigger memories for me, and then I pray for my family. And like, I'm sure, what reminds everyone, what's a symbol that's a dad symbol, right? Probably a hot dog. Like, you know, our parents don't really eat that, but they'll always bring you a hot dog from Costco. So if I get that kind of triggered thought, I'll have a quick prayer. And yeah. And the prayer is more like a flex of, I stopped thinking about Twitter and superficial to go back to family. And it can't be dark. I used to have dark prayers about, like, keep my family safe. Dude, it's not a drama, bro. It's not, that's ritualistic prayer. That's not good. That's drama that you don't want. It's not that it's invoking anything. It's just, there's nothing God ever does that's bad. Everything is your warped perception. Because, listen, everything coming down from God is good. And when something goes wrong in your life, you ruin your relationship with God trying to change His will. But the truth is, it was going great for you before that. So you fell off the beat, you know, you fell off the path. And another thing is, like, if you've ever had those dreams where you wake up and that nightmare's over, yeah, one day you're going to wake up and all your suffering is, it's over. You're right. I don't know if I should share this. Yeah, people who have had a psychedelic trance, I've never done psychedelics, but I'm talking about in other ways. If you've ever bathed in the solar splendor of God, if you've seen it, as much as it fades and you forget, you always feel like, wow, the ending's good. Like, if you've ever had that. So there's some people who are like 30 who, I don't know, I'm talking about the spiritual guys. Religious guys never really feel that. But I'm talking about the guys who took it far, right?
I am Ian Price, donated $5. Wanted to genuinely thank you, brother, because you played a fundamental role in bringing me to Christ, and my life has changed 100% for the better.
I'm talking about visually seeing it, if you've ever triggered that part of your brain.
Zerka, when a parent loses a child and blames God, what's the right way to give advice?
I would never give someone advice that's going through that. They need understanding, right? They don't need advice. They need care. They don't need advice. They need someone there. They don't need advice. That's a very, like, MTV way to look at things. But the trials and tribulations people go through, I don't want to, like, make it small, but everyone loses their family one day. And the pain's going to be the exact same for everyone. So, if we're all on the same train, all you got to do is say, what does my family want me to do? And I'll tell you this, bro. Most people who lose a family member never carry out what their family wanted for them. They just forget. And it's fucking horrific. And the fulfilled people actually complete their family's wishes, right? Or this is the worst part, is if you don't know what they wanted for you. But maybe you guys weren't close. And, like, bro, growing up, you'll have a watch that you hate that one day you will stab someone if they try and take it from you because your dad gave it to you when you guys were, like, when you were a kid. That's like a part of carrying out their energy. You know, their energy has to live through you or else you die, right? Like, how the fuck? That energy brought you here to life and you're telling me you can go on without it? Yeah. I think the best thing my dad ever gave to me was unlimited confidence. Yeah. Well, he still does it. Like, we still... If you guys knew how close I am with my dad, you guys would be like, yo, that's a little too close, bro. Like, you know what I mean? That's... We're like... Like, Mike would look like a stranger if you saw me with my dad. Mike would look like a stranger to me. Like, that's way close. And Mike would say the same thing about... He was super close with his dad, like... But Mike's a soldier, man. You know, when his father passed, he's like, got his life going. Popped off, did everything. And then, you know, it unravels like this, but... He don't stop. There's so many people who freeze after something like that. This guy's never frozen, bro. He just keeps going. Yeah. Yeah. He's about 6 feet. Yeah, no, as much as I love religion for you guys, it's not really the black belt of spirituality. You know, spirituality is you alone. Like, the church ain't gonna do much for you, bro. There's when you, the religion is just the white belt, you got to get into it, man. Then it's about you. Yeah. I don't have an exact date for anything, you know. I'll just go with the. First of all, I got to get you guys that documentary, so we got to pick that up. That's happening. That's priority one. And then. Miami and give you guys some normie content and just spike viewers like that. And then what's my boxing update? I won my trial by snapping right in the last second, and now I'm just getting surgery. And like, fucking, I just need one of them anyway, really. Yeah. But I don't like to say that live because it's like people have to get me and shit. Like, well, I just always think that. Like, you know how streamers are? And I'm like, fuck, bro. Just wait a bit.
Bird Rodeo donated $5. Born on January 16th year of the Dragon 11 life path, I have some motion on my social media. But still work at a warehouse. Should I just double down on social media?
You have a 7 and a dragon? That's Putin. And 11's great. And you're never going to... There's no number that's going to DM me and say, should I double down on social media? You're never going to hear Zerka say no. Okay? Like, I'm like... to my brother makes great money, but I'm like, you should be on YouTube tripling that, you know? I'm trying to do, get him in there.
$5. Every time I watch these streams, I feel like I have the IQ of a dog, no meat riding. I've never heard more wisdom from any mainstream speaker. How do you get into a flow state like this and clear brain fog?
Read books. When you're reading books, you're not downloading the information. You're unlearning what you've already been taught. That's where you sound... That's when you start saying profound shit. It's like, you'll never see a clip of me... where I sound like a TikTok advice channel. Because it's like from the heart. See, now it sounds like TikTok. I'm talking from the heart, bro. I fucking ruined it right there. My first gay clip. Fuck. But you know what I'm saying, right? Like, you know your ancestors and everything in your unconscious and collective unconscious. You know that everyone has... Any human can tap into genius for 2 weeks, a month. Some people can yank it. Tesla yanked it to, what was it, 80% of his life since 11 years old or some shit. Yeah, you have it in you, but why ancient Egyptians and all these ancient cultures would, the state would mandate thought in the correct way, meditation and all that, thought loops, because the elites fucked you up, bro. 99% of your thoughts are not yours because you learned it from social media. And your inner thoughts are genius, like literal ancestral DNA type shit. But they're clouded by that phone of yours, which is, it's like scrying. Was it scrying? Scrying? It's a black mirror, your phone. It's a crystal ball, but it's a mirror. And it's going to send you into delusions. And, you know, I know this hurts my paycheck severely, but even bigger than going to God, watch me get a bunch of hate for saying this. Get off social media. That's more important than... There's so many guys who are scrolling through a nude feed while they have God in their heart. And, dude, I'm telling you, you're not winning that fight ever. You're never going to win that fight. Like, because here's why you can't get off social media, is then you don't have a social life. But a normal person gets off social media and goes to his friend group. So that's the tricky part. Or if you get paid off social media, right? That's even trickier. But yeah, I think step one, you should just look in your history and see how much, like everyone who's ever hired me, the part where they want to cry is not me saying anything mystical. It's when we're just unsubscribing from every single channel. And they look in my eyes and they go, how come you're not looking at which channels, John? Like, you're not looking to see what kind of content. What if it's good Christian content? I go, no, unsubscribe from all of it. Because it's not serving you right now. So that means it's not working. Just go to zero. And then they go, okay, what should I subscribe to? I go, unsubscribe from me too. And they go, what? I'm like, yeah, you came to me because it's not working for you, you fucking idiot. And they're like, okay, how do I watch your... Well, if you need to watch me, you can always click on my channel, but you're not getting notified by me. You're not watching all my shit. You have a lot of time on your hands now. You know, you're at zero. So as soon as their social media status is at zero clickbait content, so they just get a normal feed on YouTube algorithm that they don't fuck with, that's the healthy part. And then we zero their thoughts. So we train you to go, I don't need that. I don't need that. I don't need that. And you're always going to zero, right? For all your thinking process. And then if it's what you want to do, your dreams, you stay on that thought. And you keep building that. You get tired, go eat a meal. Get distracted. Nope, I don't need that. And then don't go back to working on your dreams. Just rest. And then go back to your dreams. But you never actually go back to... I don't know why people are so afraid to be addicts about drugs. You should be afraid of social media addiction. That's... Like, who are you if you unsubscribe from everything? You're nobody. So that means you're the fakest person on earth, because you have a sense of persona identity from the streamers that you're laughing with. No. No, the streamer's making a joke. You're not individuating at all. I am, but you're not. Like, I'm going up Jacob's ladder and you're watching me go up the ladder. Isn't this a one-sided transaction, bro? You know? So, and people are like, I swear to God, my whole life, every 2-3 weeks, I unsubscribe from every single channel that helped me. And I get new channels. Why? Because those are my February channels. Now it's March. And if I didn't soak up the info, then I fucked up. You know, I can't go back. It's over.
Rotten Aquid donated $5. Yo, you brought me back to God. Jesus is king. I've been seeing 28 every day in the time multiple times. Does that mean anything?
It means you crave wealth. Well, I'm not going to tell you. The meaning comes from you. It doesn't come from me. Right? Like, 28 to a wealthy person means something else to them, you know? And you shouldn't look for signs. That's like very stupid. It's not black magic. It's just stupid and low IQ. Synchronicity is a feeling. It's sensation. It's intuitive. It'll hit you. So if you're seeing 28 everywhere, what does that mean? Clearly, it means nothing because you're asking what does it mean. When you get hit by something that's meaningful, you feel it. So you go, Zirka, 28, I saw it and I felt this and it reminded me of this. Yeah, that's the meaning. I don't know what the fuck 28 means for you, right? What does Latina fat ass mean to you versus to me? To me, it's like something I'll have in the summertime. To you, you have that thought in you January, February, every month of the year. So to you, it's your God. To me, it's like a fucking weekend in the summer. Right. Is reality shifting real? There's nothing else. There's nothing else that I know to be real except that. That when your consciousness expands even slightly, that Ferrari is just next to you. It's your friends, though, but you have better friends. And then your consciousness expands one more time, and now it's your Ferrari. And it's weird, bro. It's...
Yeah. Bird Rodeo donated $5.
How are we doing?
What's your favorite method to reprogramming your subconscious? I don't really listen to music, audiobooks, but what else is best?
I like to do imposter syndrome. So when I had 1 year of imposter syndrome and I got really fucking dark, I got really toxic and I went back to some stupid shit. But imposter syndrome is the most healthy thing you can go through. Like, Zirka loves rap music, but only listens to Beethoven and feels like an imposter all day. Yeah, but this Zirka's making more than every kick streamer, and he streams once every 2 weeks. Like, kick streamers on my level, I'm saying, you know? Like, I fucking shit on Citrus. You know what I mean? And he's close to the money. He's close to the Jewish. You know what I mean by that? And people are like, yeah, but Zirka used to do 22 hours streaming every day. I don't stream. And I'm beating that Zirka. Every year you guys watch me, I'm a better Zirka. More rich. Better looking. More bitches. That's someone going up the ladder. And I don't know how streamers have the same paycheck year after year. I haven't had 1 year where my paycheck doesn't triple. Ever. And if it does, I'll lose my fucking mind. Not anymore now. Because now I know that there's plateaus that you have to be passive on, not active. If you're active on plateaus, you lose your mind a bit. And it's greedy too, right? You don't want to deal with avarice as you're going up. Because that never ends. That's like lust. You know, you don't want to deal with lust because it never... Heel Mike will pipe 1,000 bitches. Is he satisfied? Is he... No. His thirst is actually growing more. The desire doesn't stop inflating just because you nutted. Okay, that hole needs to be filled with something. That's why there's no better feeling than your career is saving souls. So I found God because of you. Well, I'm getting rich because you're saying that, bro. Thank you. But I'm also doing one thing correct. Thank God. You know what I mean? That's balancing. That's such so healthy for me. I can't imagine having a career like the rest of the world, where they go to bed and they don't have one email like that. They just go to bed like, oh, I sold a car. Like, well, then fucking kill yourself. No, don't do that. But you know what I mean? Like, yeah. 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 Also, it gives me room to be stupid. I don't beat myself up when I'm stupid because I go, at least I'm saving souls. Like, when the chat hasn't saved one soul, I probably saved 100,000 plus souls in 1 month. You know how hard that is to do?
Adamo3 donated $5.
Holy Spirit.
You remind me of a mix between Hunter S. Thompson and Jordan Peterson. What is your opinion on those two?
I don't know Hunter too well, but as much as I shit on Zionists, Jordan Peterson's so healthy for your psyche, man. I don't like to say the individualistic thinking is everything, because that's a little Andrew Tate and hustler culture and it's a little fucking gay. But you compare someone like Tate to Peterson and, bro, why are we pretending Peterson didn't expand all of our consciousness together? Like, when he came out, it was like, you know, he's great. I love Peterson. I don't like the book that much. The Sit Up Straight book.
Jesus Lord donated $5. It seems I can only remember the end of my dream. Since you're interested in dreaming, do you like the movie Inception? Tips to start dreaming more. It seems I only can dream like once a week.
The number one thing you can do for that is, what is your routine before bed? If you're not ridding yourself of anxiety before bed through a system, have you ever slept flexed? Like half your body's tense? That's not sleep, dude. You're hurting your money doing that. I'm telling you, you are, I don't care if it takes you 10 minutes or 2 hours, you need your brain at zero when you're going to bed. And that means one look at your Twitter before bed, even on low brightness, will spike it to 1,000. And it'll take you another hour to take it to zero. So this is the most frustrating thing if you're not doing it correct. So, yeah, sleeping tense is, means you're on your phone before bed. And here, here's your best sleep you've ever had. You went to a lake house with your family. Everyone had fun. They were playing in the water. You got tired in the water. You guys go back, have some marshmallows, and you touch your bed and you go to bed. You don't look at your phone. That kind of vacation sleep. That's how your whole life should be. And I spent 29 years of my life doing it wrong. So you're not behind. I think I just started doing this right last year. Well, not even like, we'll look at last year. We'll say last few months, because last year I was doing it right half the week, which is so horrible. Yeah, shout out Marion and I love Hoshman's. Yeah, they're real as fuck. They're the only people I watched religiously. Like, they're awesome. Do you ever do dopamine detoxing? Yeah, I mean, I haven't been to LA or Miami in months. And that's where, like, my life gets colorful, right?
Donated $5. Right. Please don't pretend the dating course will get you money for the next 20 years. Save whatever you get from it now, and play it safe for when you grow old. The more you pretend money will always come, the more you will fuck yourself up for...
What, are you retarded? Are you fucking... Bro, last year I could do fucking 10K viewer streams and I wouldn't make money like today. With these lower viewers, like, are you, money will always come to people who know what they're doing, because money is just energy. That's all it is. If you know how to manipulate energy, you're golden, right? And how do you manipulate energy? Don't do it. Start with manipulating yourself. That's an energy source. And then you're a magnet. It's, dude, money is valves. You turn a couple of valves and it starts flowing. Then you go back to your old habits and it stops. Then you turn them back on and they're flowing. And a smart man just turns on the valves and keeps them open. And they all doing something. And he just stays in his higher self and doesn't go back to being an idiot. That's it, right? But yeah, money is super healthy. If you're not making money in life, you're with the devil. 100%. Okay? Like when the Bible says you have to sweat from the brow, who the fuck doesn't get paid from sweating from the brow? What?
The Eagle donated $5. Before I go to sleep, I sleep in the state I desire to be in, and doze off into that feeling, and I make sure to wake up in that state.
Dude, if you're waking up on edge, you're doing everything wrong. It's very simple. Okay? I'm not saying getting out of bed is easy. You know? Mornings suck for everyone, for most people. Like, who hates the morning time? It takes like an hour to roll out of bed and But the point is, you get it done. Because there's guys who stay in their bed till they're sweaty. If you're staying in bed till you're sweaty, you just can't get up, you're like stone, that's severe depression. That's... Yeah.
Willie Bouncepin donated $5. Tips for jawline maxing.
Someone in chat said it recently about, like, because I don't give fake advice. Like, I don't know what the mewing shit is and stuff. Like, I don't even buy into it that much. So I don't really answer questions like that. But someone in chat said, Zoomers don't eat hard foods. And I'm like, oh my God. That is so true. You know what I mean? Like, I can't think of cheese. I think of cheeser drinking yop. Or you guys don't know what that is. Like, they like their yogurts, and I like the yogurt too, but you know how much red meat I've had in my life? Like, I've never had a week without, like, four steaks, which is not good. It actually ages you if you look into it. But we're talking about jaw. I've had a lot of hard things in my... What the fuck are we talking about? What is your take on low vibrations or high vibrations? It's always balancing them. So people with low vibes need to go high, not high. And people with high vibrations, you gotta be like me. Like, I have very high energy, and then if I balance it out and talk to make a few fucking business calls with my team, everything goes up. Oh, but if I stay high, I got high vibration, I'll do it myself, and that's working too many hours. Like, no, if you're working a shit ton of hours and you're making a shit ton of money, you're killing creativity. And creativity is like, you make one good album, that's $10 million. Like, there's work and projects in between work. That's how life goes, right? So for like a book, Zerka does these streams, the good stuff I say gets clipped up, it gets stored in a file that gets put into a book in bullet form with the real thought that I'm trying to express. And that's how the book is made, right? And then I make up 20 mil off that book.
DDG underscore representative donated $5. As a Destiny fan who've been watching you since 2018, I'm proud of the numerology grift for easy money. I remember when you told Sneeko you only do it cause it makes you a lot of money.
True.
Top G.
True. But that's not where most of my money comes from. It's from manipulation and dating. Numerology is just, like, most people who sign up $500 for a call with me, they go, okay, thank you for the hidden numbers. That's cool. I just want the law of attraction, but paint it for me. Don't give me no bullet form, this is what you do. Paint it for me. And so then I'll begin with the highest level manifestation. You know that word, the gay word? The highest level law of attraction is a poet. Because if you guys say, I have a Ferrari, that didn't bring a picture to anyone's head. But if you say there's honeydew dripping off the V8 of my brand new Ferrari. Now, that image in your head that went from shadow to form, that is how you manifest. That's why these poets would be like Shakespeare level famous, because everyone knows what they're doing with that kind of a mind. That's why poets, they say, are the closest to understanding God, because they can literally do God, the imagination God gave them, justice. And remember, Floyd Mayweather doesn't believe in God and stuff, but he holds on to the imagination that he's number one. And God rewards him and says, hey, if that vision's that clear to you, you deserve it. That's how it works. Like, you don't have to be with God to get blessings from God. It's just the 100% certain way is. Your actions can be towards, let's say you want to take care of your family and stuff. You think God's not going to notice that in Floyd? No, he's going to notice that in Floyd. Like, what do you think? It's just about, what is this Protestant preaching, bro? You think it's just you saying it? Berserker, would you take a mic? Or would you take a beating like Mike? No, bro. Bro, what are you talking about? Fuck Mike. Is that what you want me to say? Get the fuck out of here. Destiny's opposite. Destiny's ruled by a thing that rules over me, like, for a month of the summertime. Like, I pipe some bitches and I do what Destiny does. But he's ruled by it year round. Like, if Destiny doesn't have the idea of piping a chick in his head, he doesn't do a 12-hour stream. He's perfect at sexually transmuting energy. Because he just does the treat. If I do a 12-hour stream, I can go to her house, just finish it, stay on top, stay on. That's exactly how nerds should go. Like, if you're more nerdy about it.
Rotten Aquid donated $5.
Yeah.
Do all dreams have a deeper meaning, and how do you go about interpreting them? I had a dream where I shot an old friend after he shot at me first, but I still called an ambulance for him. Also, any book suggestions, and how do I book a numerology?
Yeah, you didn't shoot your friend, you shot yourself. Because in most of the characters in your dreams are going to be you fighting you. So, you should look into that. But it's not the meaning you want. It's you want dream amplification. So, what we do is you tell me everything you saw in the dream and we amplify it. Because you have to get all the pieces and the image starts coming back to you. You just want to amplify the dream. You don't want to actually know the meaning. Like, well, you want to, but you're not going to actually have the meaning. You just want the amplification. That's the symbols. That's all you need. Symbols is how you can go into that world of forms in your head, that imaginative kind of, that I'll call it it's ritualistic because it's play, right? What you play with happens. What you will does not happen without play, you know? Like, I play with my money and it comes into spades. It comes in spades. Or I can do a 20-hour stream and it can come to me in a... It has a bottleneck. It has a, you know, there's a restriction there. Busting my ass type shit, right? So now I choose, like, okay, I can do 4 hours of work, 2 hour break, and the break is play. I'm playing with imagination. And you should see my team, Dead Hex and Diminish. All I do is predict the jumps. I'm like, we're going to go up 2K this week. Then we're going to go up 10K next week. And then all my predictions go correct because I know how much time it takes. Well, I don't know. I'm guessing.
He's donated $5. This nigga really thinks the plane is gonna blow up on the way to Miami because of a gas dragon your enemy.
No, Eclipse. Eclipse is why I think it. I watched a Boeing video and now I'm terrified. The door came off and I'm terrified. Someone opened the fucking door.
How do you check your star chart, planet alignment during your birth date? Is there a particular website? Also, could you give a brief explanation on each of the planets and their meanings if they are present during your birth?
There's only three things you check for, and 99%, I'm not even being sales guy right now, bro. 99% of astrology on YouTube, I swear they talk about retard shit. Just get into sidereal Vedic. There's the only guys that can give you at least 5% of what you need to know. Everything else is, it's off, and it's not even geocentric, so they're really off. And number two, the planets are different. Like, an idealistic version of myself would be like a Kim Kardashian first house Neptune. So I have that. But for me, it runs delusion too, because it rules the imagination and the unconscious. And it's spiritual as fuck. That's why when I talk about God, everyone comes here. But if another streamer talks about God, it's kind of like they're talking about God with Mercury in the first house. It's like very logical and thinking and things. It's stupid, right? But yeah, there's only three things you check for, and the things that are conjunct or opposite. And like, I only look for the big stuff. A good one would be like, Connor's got a Jupiter in his identity house. That's money. Jupiter brings you money.
My ex broke up with me 5 months ago, and I can't escape her out of my mind. I want to forget her ass. Sometimes I even have dreams of her. I distract myself by doing good habits, gym, my purpose, etc.
Yeah, you're never going to get her back because you want her back. But your want is building the world that you don't have.
Niggas donated $5. Stop living in fear and come to Miami.
Shut
Nobody
the fuck
is
up,
going
bro,
to rip the door off the plane.
just relax, bro, because let me tell you this, bro. I'm gonna live in Miami. Like, when I'm there, I'm never leaving. So I'll be there for the rest of my life. Like, you're gonna get bored of it, trust me. You're gonna get bored of Miami as well. Like, it's not like I'm coming back here, you know. Just relax, bro. Also, these streams are better for you, bro, because you're still a watcher. You just watch to be entertained. That means you're numbing yourself to something you're running from. You should probably learn something. Pick up a pencil like hundreds of thousands of other people who changed their lives watching my shit. You don't want to be that part of chat. Because we are bored. I'll tell you this, dude. Only women get bored. Like, how can you be bored in God's world? Like, you're like a whore. You're bored. So turn the channel off, bro. This is like the self-help network. One in the chat if I should never stop helping my chatters. Because, dude, there's very few people living out their dream life. You know, like a Hollywood celebrity can't say what they want. That's not the dream life that they want. You know, I'm getting both worlds. Celebrity status saying what the fuck I want. You know? And ban that guy, bro. Just ban him. You're getting negative, bro. Easy, my king. You gotta go. Okay? And your mom's a fucking faggot. Okay? She's a whore. And we spit on your whore mother in this chat. There you go. Yeah. Manifest the spit off her fucking face. That fucking dirty rat whore mother you have. Yeah, been watching me for years. Yeah, John Zerka thinks your mother's a whore. Thank you for watching me for years. I like the money, faggot. And look, now the whole chat is saying your mother's a whore. That is a lot. And you know what's funny? Even God thinks your mother's a whore. That's what's funny. Or else, why the fuck would he speak it through me? I'm kidding. This is way too funny. Jesus Christ. Where the fuck am I going with that? I'm possessed by God right now. And I'm kidding. Yeah. Let's
go, pal. I'm making a withdrawal here. Thijachi donated $5. I don't want her back. My life was good before I met her.
Cope.
I just want to be back to where I was. High vibrations. I was a magnet in attracting all the good in my life.
Chad, does he want her back? You wouldn't bring her up to me if you didn't want her back. And dude, step one of wanting someone back in your life is you're putting out in the quantum field that you don't have her, which means the quantum field is going to change the matrix so you can't have her. That's so dangerous what you're doing, bro. Like, change your thinking, change your language, right? You already have her. She doesn't have you. That's what's happening here. Jesus. And bro, honestly, I don't have sympathy. If you don't have abundance of girls texting you, you're a faggot. You set up your life wrong, right? Like, no girl can give me stress. Like, John, I'm just going to leave you. And I go, don't leave me, because then I'll start smashing every bitch in my phone. And they go, what? I go, yeah. Like, keep me normal. And they go, why? And I go, I get lonely. And they go, what the fuck? I'm like, yeah, I'm very lonely. And they go, okay, maybe we can work on our problems, Sean. I go, thank you. Don't want to be back to whores. I like having one girl to, you know, be around. But now think of it like this. If I didn't have bitches, she would literally just leave. She'd be like, oh, I'm not going to stick around with this guy. Like, what the fuck? So, give me your number one advice on losing weight. Practical stuff would be fast until late at night, so you're not spiking your insulin and being hungry, and the hungers go away very quickly. Within a few days, you'll be used to fasting. And then step two, if you eat 300 grams of protein as your first meal versus 300 grams of carbs, which is cereal, so steak or cereal, you can finish that cereal in 20 seconds. And that steak's going to take you a while. So why don't you start with that steak and have a protein shake before every meal, because your stomach will turn into concrete. You can't have 3 scoops of protein before every meal and actually finish the McDonald's. It's really hard. You'll be like, ugh. So fill up your stomach with that higher percentage of 1 gram per pound body weight protein. And then also add maybe a peel of an apple. So that's high fibrous. So high protein, high fiber, activity, and you're on your way with fasting.
I Uv Jesus donated $5. Hey Zerka, is the reason why you call yourself a pedo and rapist a part of karmic retribution? the belief that you have to admit what you are in order to get away with it? Is that also why you wear the Masonic symbol?
No, I'm not a pedophile. I'm not a rapist. Do I sound like I'm lying right now? Yeah, it's more of a middle finger to society. I'm like an outlaw, bro. You tell me I can't talk about murdering children and I'll start talking about murdering children. Like, that's who I am. That's my nature. Haven't you watched me before? I literally do what you tell me I can't do. Because, yeah, something fucked up with me there. But, no, I've never been a pedo. And, I mean, you know the people I date. I think I've dated one 18-year-old, and that's it. Now, if I only dated very young, it's not the smoking gun, but you definitely build a case. Let's go, pal. I'm
here to win. Yeah. Rotten Aquid donated $5. What's your thoughts on Robert Greene? Is he a faggot or is he spitting? Seems like his books are best for developing a certain type of ego. Is that even a thing?
I don't know anything about that, but Neville Goddard's good for the kind of stuff you're looking for. That's a good start. Yeah. Karmic retribution, though. I'm sure I've done it, but not for that stuff. Maybe
I've donated $5.
Subconsciously done.
Best way to suppress appetite? Bro, I am constantly craving and I can't help it. I've spent $700 this week on Five Guys already. Please help.
You should probably talk to your doctor, because these people who have binge eating disorders, you don't have a binge eating disorder. For example, there's something that there's a trauma in your life that's making you do this kind of neurotic impulsive behavior. And for example, if you stop doing the Cheetos, you'd replace that dopamine hit with coke. So a coke addict is the same as an obese person, and an obese person is the same as a coke addict. It's just you want more and more and more. And therapy is way more effective than trying fad diets. But also, it's like when you appeal to your higher self, you're gonna disassociate the taste of food with something good. You're gonna associate it with being a fat slob. And that higher self, you can do anything. That's Goggins, bro. But you gotta unpack some of your shit, man.
Soza Nugget donated $5. Jesus is God. Born on the 7LP, 7 Virgo, Tiger. Bro, do I go to the gym at night then if I want to fast? I'm trying to be more outlaw. Should I do boxing?
Well, didn't you say you want to lose weight? No, go to the gym fasted while your hormone profile is higher. And the whole point of fasting is that if your eating window is you can only eat for 4 hours a day, that cuts a lot of calories weekly. So your net calories weekly is like, for skinny guys will be like, I eat all the time, but they're just eating a lot on Monday and Tuesday, and then they don't eat for the rest of the week. Weekly, that's what matters. So if you're calorie shaving, fasting is a good way to, 1 hour window would be great. Yeah. I like one meal, but, I think you should start with like a more realistic window, because yeah. Another thing is you need a career and social life. Cause have you noticed a lot of you guys that I talk to tell me when you guys were social before COVID, you weren't eating that much. Like, if you have a career and people to talk to, you forget about food. They're filling your dopamine in other ways. You know what I mean? So it's like your loss of self is the first thing you should address, like who you were. Because, yeah. Yeah. Or you could do what Derek from More Plates, More Dates does, right? What does he recommend for you binge eaters? I forgot what it's called, but he has a ton of clients in the comments who say he's really good at the... Derek's really good.
Jachi donated $5.
But I don't want to do fitness.
Thank you, my nigga.
Thank you.
That's actually the best advice. I didn't even think about what I was doing to the quantum field by my thinking. In all aspects of life.
The way he says it. Yeah. Yeah, if you're ever beating yourself down, it's why you're a loser. Like, look at immigrants who make it in the West. When they come to America, they have very, I am already a genius. I am a millionaire. I just don't have the money yet. I am, right? And you look at immigrants who don't make it in life, I just don't have, I got another parking ticket, I got faggot language, faggot thinking. Yeah. Let's go,
pal. I'm making a withdrawal here. Zillow donated $5. Nigga, holy shit, you're right. When I was playing football for high school and was going to parties and hanging out with friends, I completely forgot about food and was actually in shape.
Yeah. Yeah. Especially women. Like, if you're around chicks, your dopamine goes, damn, I kind of want her to pet me. But if you're around, like, cheeseburgers, you go, that burger better pet me, you know? I can do it all. I've been a skinny bitch. I've been a fat bitch. I can do it all. So I get, but it's all different psychic frames. It's not really, like, for example, never work out again. I have a client who can never work out again, and I can get him lean, right? If I focus just on his mindset, the diet will get him there. You know, like, it's not that answer of go to the gym is not real. Don't go to the gym. Don't fix your diet. Don't do anything till you fix your mind. Once you're appealing to your higher self, the food choices become a lot easier and the training becomes a lot more fun. And this is vision work. You have to, if you're not seeing a vision, the molding isn't going to happen. You're not going to have that kick in your mind that goes, actually, go leaner. And the guys who are really good with their minds, they get six packs and they go, I need 15 more pounds to lose. That's a solid mind. That mind is turning into stone at that point. And then I'd usually look at their money. I'll be like, actually, you're losing, like, monthly, you're making less because of this six pack you're obsessing over. So that means you're not going to hold that six pack. Because if you're losing one way, it's going to bounce. You got to find the equal.
Black people do half of the crime donated $5.
Bro.
You should make a guide to manifesting. What type of stuff do you do to manifest? Believing you deserve it. Writing it down. What else?
Yeah. Here's some basics from my clients. But thinking, intuition, feeling, and sensation. These are the elements of earth, air, fire, and water. Not in that order, though. I'm not going to tell you. This is your first, the first symbols you play with in your mind, right? So with the zodiac, there's different signs that, well, you probably know. Like, for example, I genuinely think you guys are all the thinking type. Most of you guys are the thinking type. And the guys who have channels, you guys are probably the feeling types. You know, like, you have all of them, but most of the chat overthinks. Am I crazy? That's why they're chatters. And that's, like, the number one issue. So if your mind is overthinking a lot, it's avoiding play. And that's a big no-no. Your mind has to go to play. While it can't be play like you're playing, what's that called? Roadblocks or whatever you guys do. Play means play with, you know, your imagination. Like, you gotta see what you're trying to build. So that's, manifestation is just play. That's why the Queen and King of England hold a scepter and do that ritual, is they're doing it on a higher plane. You know, like, it's like a ceremonial magic what they're doing, but it's a magnet towards what they're trying to do. And that's also why in the Bible it says the heavens, like, the kingdom for the child brain. Like, the play brain that can, I can do anything. And the Bible says, you want it, it's yours. Believe you already have it. So that's step one, right? And that's also why God introduces himself as I am, as in do it yourself. And he's gonna, it's like a gas station. Like, he's gonna send you the fuel and you're gonna do the rest. But all good is done through God, right? All bad in your life is you perverting the good. So yeah, basically we go over intellect, feeling, amplification, and motion of thought. You want to molecularly change your thought from thinking to feeling, or feeling to thinking is the more dangerous one. But this is how you play with the idea of, oh, I am successful. And as soon as you see the vision in your head and hold on to it, you'll know the one that's real, because you'll actually hear your head say, I am successful. And then boom, your journey is started. Your habits are going to change over time. And usually within less than 7 days, you're going to let go of it and take a break. And now you got to start from beginning. So you've lost, because people are like, I think about manifesting all the time. Yeah, but that's not play. Your imagination is not thinking, it's play. That's how it creates. Like, your imagination played into your divorce, right? When you picked up a girl, you were playful with her. That's how you magnetically got her. It's not a, you didn't think so hard. No, thinking is like your bitch, a little tool, right? And then the tool starts owning you when you're overthinking. We go over that. We go over faith. And then the most important one is second nature. You do something 28 days, it cracks into second nature. That's subconscious. So if you could be positive for 28 days straight, which is a lot harder than it looks, bro. This is a whole moon, bro. But if you can do that, everything you're doing becomes second nature. And then it gets amplified the next month, next month, next month. Yeah, and then you'll hit me up. Zirka, I fucked up. For 3 days, I was negative. Well, you lost. It's over. Don't come to me anymore. You lost. I don't even want to help you anymore. If you can't do 28 days, why the fuck would I restart with your faggot ass? I know so many guys who went through so much shit, and they did 28 days straight and had good results. You fucking lost. Or the worst is the guys who will lose when it's second nature. This is fucking horrible, bro. That's a fucking failure. Yeah. Like, if you watch all my streams in 2024, it's like best year ever. It's all the same energy as this guy, right? Because this is the winning energy. But I'm not going to lie. Sometimes I do get, like, the tail starts to wag and I go, I want to go faster. And no. Faster is middle path always, right? Yeah. I could retire my parents. They got money, though. The fuck? They love the world.
In Canada? Steve Yachty donated $5. What? I like reading Neville Goddard's work. He really brought me closer to the Bible by incorporating scriptures into his work about manifestation. Yeah. My favorite book is Out of This World. Mark 11:24 asks, I believe it's...
I worry about that, because everyone who gets into Goddard's work, I've noticed that they fail miserably, because then they're so hooked. They're so hooked on his work that they go to other practices. And dude, 99% of the manifestation market is like single moms selling you books on Amazon. They're raping you. So that's why I say Goddard and Carl Jung is the best way to deal with psychic processes. You know, these are the guys, because Jung's going to tell you the issues, how to spot for them, and Goddard's going to tell you the ideal higher self. So this is a good, Jung's a little complicated for you guys, because if you don't understand all the terms, it can get very weird. So you should understand self, unconscious, anima, shadow, everything, right? Yeah. Zirka would be blue pill without his dad in life. Yeah, I actually think that, yeah. I feel like people without dads are always faggots. Like, have you noticed that? Like, people who grew up without dads are always faggots.
Rotten McQueen donated $5. How the fuck do you retain so much of what you read? Is it the drawing? I've been highlighting what I read, so I'm consciously reading. Is that a good tactic?
No, I do it in a hypnagogic state. So, I do it in between consciousness and unconsciousness. So I play with thoughts. I don't read when I'm like, I'll read with a coffee, but if I'm not learning, I stop. I don't take a break. I leave it alone until it goes back to play. But most of my learning is done in between wakefulness and sleep, like the Tesla method. And I have a method for that that's really detailed for my guys. And yeah, I can't say that word. But yeah, I used to do it. I had no idea how much I used to do it when I was bouncing. But all random topics, kind of random. Should have been one topic.
Donated $5. My 77 ass, I live in my head, bro. What could I do to break it in social situations?
What? Double seven?
I treat it like a job, like you said when I was single. Is it possible now that I'm in a relationship?
Well, I don't get the question. What did he say? Double seven, I heard? You can't fully grow from a broken starting point. There is no health. Bro, every human is broken, bro. Like, there's no healthy starting point. Like, check this out. This is the white pill. This is going to motivate the shit out of you. If you've been a loser for 30 years of your life, you have so much unconscious packing you can do that will leapfrog everyone else. You can tenfold surpass people because there's so much psychic content you haven't released. Plus, it's charged over that many years of you being a loser. So that's why if you look at most inventors and geniuses, 55 years old, then they make $1 billion, right? You look at most geniuses in high school, they're nobodies today. So yeah, if you're a loser for 40 years of your life, hit me up because you've got, I want to take percentage off you type shit. Yeah, it's just those habits are strong to break. If you've been a loser for 40 years, you're probably really stuck in your ways type shit. Stuck in the fucking dirt. So yeah, okay, we'll wrap it up soon. How do I improve focus when studying? Just study without caffeine as long as you can for as many hours, and then incorporate coffee. I don't ever, well, I always have a coffee when I'm studying. So no, don't do that. Stretch it, stretch your regular psychic ability, right? Oh, I can do this. I'm awake. I can do this. I'm learning. Stretch that. It's kind of also with feeling good. If you feel good, don't take coffee. Don't have a cigarette. Don't have nothing. Stretch the feel good as long as you can, right? So if your buddy offers you a drink, but you feel really good, nah. Hey, we'll have shots, but not right now. In 15 minutes, stretch it. 15 more, 2 hours pass, and then you only have one drink at night. But yeah, because a lot of times you're in a good mood and one coffee spikes your anxiety or alcohol ruins you. And it's like, dude, you have to always, every second, be checking the moment. Be like, am I good? Oh, shit, I am good. Let's not get off that vibration because I could play a rap song and your goodness can shift. I could play Beethoven, your goodness could last. But the whole point is holding the goodness. Like, I won't even play Beethoven if I feel good. When I get a little fucking anxious and shit, I haven't done enough today, then I'll, let's get the harmonics against the fuck. Let's get some Beethoven going in this house. And, it really works. Really fucking works, yeah. But the whole thing is coaching yourself through your higher self. He's chilling with God, bro. He's not even real. He's just smiling and waiting for you to fulfill his mold. So that guy should be checking in on you and, you know.
Let's go, pal. I'm making a withdrawal. Yeah. Giordani donated $5. John, evil. There's a video of Trump and his wife looking at the eclipse. Wouldn't his hermetic mage have told him not to look at it?
Dude, we're in such a material world that the last people who will listen to advice are the egos like Trump, right? I know Trump had a Kabbalah teacher, so I know. But Trump's the kind of guy to stare at an eclipse and say, I have perfect karma, and I'm going to make a wish on this motherfucker. You know? Or if you had sex during the eclipse, you're in for some weird shit with that girl. I guarantee you. Yeah. Because that's, sex is, spiritually, that's who you're married to in the spiritual plane. If you're... Fresh didn't do that. How do you know that? What the fuck? Yeah. Okay, should we wrap it up? One more question. Let's get the fuck out of here. I need to sleep. I was supposed to sleep, but I want to unpack this so Mike doesn't hit up Diddy and go, let's party again tomorrow type shit. You guys flood Mike's DMs and get him right. Yeah, I'll check my Twitter messages. Just say serious inquiry and we'll fill you up. And I've got so many people I got to do, bro. Do you believe in what Rudolf Steiner is talking about? Yeah, a lot of things. I had my mentor started me with Steiner, and it was too hard. But now it's starting to look a lot. Now I'm starting to connect dots. So a lot of it, yeah, he's spot on. But I've never read an author and said I believe the whole thing unless it's the Bible. But I'm not going to lie to you. I genuinely believe most of the Bible is under the Vatican. Like, I feel like we have some political versions of the Bible. And, you know, I feel like obviously we have the meat and potatoes, which is good. You can't stop that. But, yeah. Monkey? No, not tonight, guys. I mean, like, I shouldn't be doing it before bed anyway because... I'm very toxic on that shit. I have some. It takes me a while to get up. Bro, you only have this much emotional energy in a day if you're a businessman. You could spend that rapping a song in your car. And you gotta guard that energy, bro. This year, next year, and every year after that, you guys gotta win in life a percentage of my wins, and you'll be golden. Right, is women hate you and you suck and you make no money, and me saying that to you isn't making you guard yourself. That's horrible, right? Like, you guys immediately go, no, you, Zirka. You're supposed to say, nah. You're not supposed to actually fight me. So you're never going to win that. You're my chatter. If you're my chatter, I'm better than you in every single way. Every single way. Your ancestors lose to my Pinales ancestors.
Margarita donated $10. When is your interview with Alex Jones the show?
I don't know. Now, being born 21st or 23rd or 22nd, they're all charged, bro. Those are good numbers. Those are good numbers for the stuff you guys are into. You guys are into what I'm into. Yeah. Yeah, I'll always maintain 22 is the strongest number, bro. Because 22 is all in gematria. If you look at the Jewish gematria, 2 is 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. If you're seeing 2s, that's bringing you the diversity, balance, and the scales of winning and losing. So that's... Because 3-3 is more just winning. You know, you never see 33s ever, like, lose, really. Except that young Pharaoh guy, he's fucking off his rocker. But he's on drugs, I think. There's people who are on drugs, and it's like, yeah, it's Trainwreck's doing Adderall. You know, that's cute. He's fucking killing it in life. And then there's people like young Pharaoh on drugs, and it's like, bro, get off them, bro. Like, what the fuck? Yeah, Trainwreck's is the reason I even found out what the fuck Addy is, because I'm like, oh, he's taking prescription Addy? Remember when he said that to his community? And I'm like, he has a big business brain, bro. Like, do you guys know him from Scuff Podcast? But that guy knows how to... I've never seen someone jump up layers in success like that. Financial layers that are... Dude, like, he's beaten journeys of success. Those are journeys. Where he's at in life, that's a journey. He has multiple journeys under his belt, bro. That's retarded, bro. Like, just a couple years ago, he was just regular streamer. It was fucking crazy what he did. Yeah. I'm gonna look in his chart. The train's gotta have some hidden 28s in there. Is having 2-3s anything near 33? No, but Rocky, was it ASAP Rocky, has 2-3s. So he's really can talk. That's really creative energy, bro. And I'll say this, bro. 3s sell better than 33s. 33s just get more influence. So, like, they have more potential. But 3s definitely talk their ass off. 33s don't. Some 33s don't sound... they sound intelligent, but... Like, Gary's 33 looks good on him because of the 7. The 7, like, he unpacks... The way Gary does a little 10-second... TikTok short is actually very, very genius, right? Like, keeps your attention. You know, Gary's like the only creator that I can actually turn on notifications and watch his shit. I'll be like, this is good shit. Like, entertaining. And you don't even have to buy into it. You could just, if I was like, I fucking didn't even like this numerology stuff, I'd watch it because the way he packages it, right? He goes, you're a fucking bitch, right to the camera. And then he adds his what he's trying to do. Also, I like Gary's traps. You know, he put two sales traps you got to choose from, and you go, I'm not falling for you, Gary, and you choose his third option that's the most expensive. He's a fucking good at what he does, bro. Like, you can't beat Gary. If you want info, he's going to get you, bro. Like, you know, he's good. Yeah, Gary's like sales genius. Very likable, too. He can surround himself with a bunch of people quickly. Like, that's hard for me. I was like, fucking leave me alone, guys. Zirka, will you become numb to the hunger of fasting? Yeah, within a couple of days. Bro, if you're in the military and you don't sleep for a week because you're just in basic military qualifications like BMQ, you adapt to that too. If they don't feed you, you adapt to that too. 100 push-ups, you adapt to that too. That's what God made you, so you can adapt to anything. So why is the diet stopping you? Fucking pussy. Well, it's not a diet. Fasting is way better than that. Plus, even if you're not dieting, fast so you guys stop your aging process for 80% of the day. Some of you guys are some ugly motherfuckers, bro. I gotta say, like, fucking, bro. Like, imagine when you meet God and you guys go, like, hey, I'm that fucking ugly guy. And, like, what? Fix that shit, you fucking. Beauty is bigger than money. If a billionaire comes in at Bugatti and he has no jawline, you go, hey, Andrew Tate, why is looking at your face so funny? Something's missing, you know, like, and then God goes, damn, your soul got deformed down there. What the fuck happened to you? Yeah, all ugly people are with the devil, right? The nicest people who have helped you in your life have symmetrical faces. They look a little cute. They look or very good looking, or they got something. Ugly people are nasty people you shouldn't even trust, right? Okay, there's one Ted Bundy that'll kill you from the good-looking guys, but very few good-looking guys are Ted Bundy, bro. You kidding? Like, there's no such thing as a good-looking rapist. The case always is that she got dumped by him and she called him a rapist. There's never been a good-looking rapist. They all look like Diddy. They all look like Harvey Weinstein. There's never been a good-looking Chad rapist. Ever. You can even tell the girls who lie. Because you don't tell me about your rape. How many girls did he rape? And then the girl goes, yeah, a lot of girls think he's creepy. No, how many did he rape? Well, no, they think he's creepy. Why are you changing it? When he raped you, did he just, like, you know, block you and go on to other girls? Every girl does this. No, I was his favorite. Rape victims don't talk like that. What the fuck? You were his favorite? That's what you're holding on to? If you got raped, you go, I don't know. Dude, I'm telling you, Chads have never raped anyone. It's the biggest myth on earth. Right? I used to believe it too. I'm like, yeah, maybe. You know, it's always the ugly guy throwing the frisbee in college that's the rapist. It's not the fucking Chad, right? Because Chads look at an unconscious girl and they go, I'm too good for you. I'll have you when you're sober. That's how they think. Chads actually believe in God. They're like, thank you, God, for this face. I know you're watching me, so when I act right. But ugly people go, you're not even looking, bro. You haven't answered me ever. I'm going to rape this bitch. Yeah, short people are rapists. Ugly people are rapists. Non-social people are all rapists. People without clout are always rapists. If you don't have clout, you're always rapist.
$5. How do you become witty? And also, you're right, the halo effect is real as hell. I had a crazy glow down, and the way the same people treat me now is absurd.
Yeah. Dude, if you ever want people to like you more, just shut the fuck up. Right? You go to a party, sit down, and people are talking to you, you go, damn, bro, that's crazy. And you just sit here and you realize how much people yap for no reason because they have anxiety, social anxiety. And just talk when you mean something. I like Inception. That's a good movie. That's it. I like Inception, but Christopher Nolan actually threw me off with Tenet. Even though you spell it backwards correctly, it's still Tenet. But shut the fuck up, you fucking faggot. Tenet was a great movie. Okay, you just didn't understand it because you'd never had a black friend. Yeah. I thought it was a great movie. Same with Napoleon. Why did it get such... People shit on Napoleon's the greatest fucking movie I've seen in 10 years. It's a really good movie. I don't know what the fuck people are talking about. Right? So a lot of short people watched that and related. We just gotta kill all short people, man. Like, what? 5'5" and you wanna pass genes to this unconscious woman? What? Are you crazy? Even if she's conscious and loves you, you're not allowed to mate. Okay? Not in this reincarnation cycle. The fuck? You want to look at your 5'2 kids and say, I got to pipe your ma. At least I got to pipe your ma. Right, I got to climb your ma. I dunkle? Or dunkle is a grown man who cuts people's hair. Men's hair. And gossips on for clout. Like, I get newsjacking, but gossiping? What the fuck, bro? And it's even weirder that he gossips when he's offline, too. Hey, John Zirka said this about me on stream because a chatter baited him. And it's like, bro. But Dunkel is feminine because his dad is in jail. Because his dad stole a plane or something. I forgot the story, and I don't want to use it against him, but I said it to his face. I was like, yeah, bro, you grew up with women. That's why you're obsessed with trying to make me look like a bad guy. All I did was platform you because I felt bad for you, because you really want to be an influencer. And it turns out, I mean, everyone has it. He'll make it one day. You just got to keep working at it. But this whole always talking about people, it's like, bro, give it a rest, bro. Like, we helped you. Just thank us. Yeah, he needs to forgive his dad, you know? The person you hate, you become. That's why a gay guy sounds like their mom. They hate their mom. They're afraid of women. That's why transgender people become the parent that yelled at them, don't cut your dick off, you fucking bitch. And then they start going, don't tell me I don't have trans rights. And they become their fucking gay-ass parents. My dad's greatest advice was, oh yeah, you want to go do weak man beta male shit? Go do it and learn your lesson. Go do it. Be like the rest of them. And then I'd look at my peers, I'm like, yo, my dad's right. My friends are faggots, bro. Like, what the fuck am I doing what they're doing? Right? You know what I mean? Like, everyone needs an inner voice that's fatherly that says, stop being a fucking homo. Homo's a temperament too. Like, dude. It's like you guys filled with grudges. I've noticed this about chatters. If you love being in people's chats, what's up with the grudges, bro? You guys hold grudges over people I forgot about. Like, this girl said this about you, John, and what? That's not even your, like, relax, bro. I forgot she even existed. I actually took a shit down her throat last time I saw her. I didn't even think she's human. I don't even have any feelings towards that. And you're rebinding them. So you're reprogramming how I feel. Like, what? Yeah. Do you have a grudge against HS? Fuck no, bro. I love all men on earth because God instructs me to. But why I didn't want to collab when he first wanted to is because I got faggot energy from him. And I still think he's the same way. Like, just, you know, like some people you don't mesh with. So I don't love his style. Like, if a British guy sat next to me and just sucked Aiden Ross off, Aiden, we got to do this. Neon, we got to do this. I would sit down and be like, why, bro? You're HS. Like, don't you have your own social media? Like, are you running around with children sucking them off? You're supposed to call them little Jew and fucking little Indian bitch. You're supposed to be a man. You're not supposed to beg for clout. And I feel like he needs a dad in his life to tell him, like, you don't want those clips haunting you where people post clips of, like, now Aiden hates him and stuff, and that looks like he got disowned. But I can't look like I'm disowned because I called him a Jew since day one. I didn't call him a Jew. What am I saying? Yeah. There's some people who have character and stuff, and I go, why not reach for it more? Why? I don't know. So yeah, do I hate him? 0%. But that style, I hate that style. It was like when Heel Mike said that thing. Yeah, I like that Aiden made the kick platform. What did he say? I was like, bro, I don't like this style. This is not, humans shouldn't talk like this, bro. H's dad left him. Bro, God bless Harrison, whatever, what's his last name? God bless Harrison. I don't want him to change his ways. I don't want him, I don't have anything. He's, everything is correct for him, but he lets girls lick his butthole. And he said it's hot, like it's a turn on. That has to be something to unpack in the unconscious. I'm not even joking. I know so many people who roll in jiu-jitsu who all are into that, and that's why they roll with men and shit. But, dude, when Heel Mike told me he's done that once, something about the asshole. And I almost bitch slapped that, I freaked the fuck out. And I almost ended the friendship, for real. And then he told me it was that time of his life. I was like, oh, wow, never mind. But, was it Ice Poseidon got jerked off by a... I'm so stupid, I thought it was a chick. So I watched the clip, I'm like, what the fuck? And then you guys told me it's a fucking guy? And I find out late, I'm like, whoa, what? And my dumbass actually watched it again. I've never done that before, but I just want to look in the eyes to see if he's a homo. He's like this.
Jay donated $5. I got two bodies, but never had a girl. Do I need more Dagon EXP before I get a long term, or just get a girl?
Just get a long term and play it right from day one, because it's going to go horrible anyway. Okay? Look, dude. If you've never had a girlfriend and you've just had hookups, you don't have confidence in the world. That means no one gave you a good morning text ever in your life. That's a fucking faggot. But I'm nothing like HS. I've never had my fucking booty played with. I've never bragged about that. I've never done what Ice Poseidon done with that thing. I haven't done Aiden smelling chairs. Don't ever say I'm anything like an influencer, bro. What the fuck are you talking about, bro? Kill myself on stream. I've never had one faggot moment in my life. Fuck are you talking about? I've never... Yeah, bro, I'm ruling her because she's... playing my fucking gooch and butthole. The fuck are you talking about on that faggot talk? Bro, what the fuck? You think anyone's fucking dad hearing that? Or fucking Ice's dad watching him get... You think these dads are fucking proud? Get the fuck out of here with that shit, bro. And that's why I say, I'm like, players are always homos. Every player is like, bro, she ate my ass. Oh, so you like your fucking, you like that asshole stimulated is what HS is saying? Is that what you're saying? Well, no, like when a hot girl does it, it feels good. You know, that's all right. That's me and the chavs, bro. Bro, it's all right. No, I think I'm going to assault you in public now. The fuck? That pissed me off more than anything. That I'm like, bro, why are you linking your legacy to me if you're getting your fucking faggot butthole licked? And this is exactly what chat does. Riles me up so it looks like I hate someone. I said this before we even had a problem.
Tom Cheese donated $5.
I swear to God there's
clips.
Don't
mean to interrupt, but can you read my numbers? Born April 29th, 1997, Ox year.
Hitler's an ox. That's all I'm going to say. Yeah. And bro, I don't care. Dunkel's tragedy where his dad went to prison. I don't give a fuck, bro. I don't feel sorry for you. If your dad went to prison, you are just like your faggot father. You have faggot DNA. Okay? Your dad's in prison, Omega lol, bro. What the fuck? What am I supposed to feel bad for you? If your dad's in prison, that says a lot about you. That you have faggot DNA. Like, women need to be watched by prison guards. That's like a woman. Can't control yourself. You're fucking locked up all the time. Right? And his dad, look at the story too. His dad stole a plane to run away from him and his mother. Like, his dad would rather be in prison than give birth to a hairdresser. He's like, my son's a faggot. I'm just going to prison for... You know, stealing an airplane is not the way people go out. That's like he couldn't even break the law. So he's like, you know what? If I steal the plane, they'll get me away from this faggot child. And bro, I don't give a fuck because Dunkel's going to see this and he's actually going to change. He's going to be like, maybe I'll stop gossiping. Maybe this is faggot behavior because I didn't have a dad in my life. And bro, I got many things I got to unpack. I'm just human, right? But one thing I'll never unpack is sitting in my bed thinking, where's my dad? Like, he's fucking right there. My dad's right here. Like, I go up to my dad. I go, hey, thanks for not going to jail. Why didn't you go to jail? And because my dad would be like this. Because you're not the faggot that I thought you were. Like, oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Nah, he wouldn't say that. My dad don't even swear. But, yeah. HS is cool, but the part where he months ago bragged about getting his fucking butthole licked, and you guys think it's games until it happens to you, bro. I swear to God, I almost punched a girl for trying. As I don't know if she was joking, but I swear to God, if police ever come to my doorstep and say, you punched this girl right in the fucking teeth because she tried to lick your asshole, I'll say, yes, officer, and I'll do it again, and I'll beat the shit out of her to death because that's rape. That's faggot rape. You get raped once, you're a faggot for life. That's how it works. If you get raped once, if one tongue touches your fucking booty hole, or this is ice beside him, like, yo, Chad, do I have more clout? Bro, there's a dude gripping another dude on camera. And I say this, being faggot for camera is worse than being a real faggot. There. Because that'll never end. There's clout here for all of you guys then. The fuck? I gotta draw the line somewhere, man. But yeah, other than that, Ice Poseidon's cool. And look, man, here's the thing. I know this is going to get me banned and in trouble in the future, but 70% of gay people are actual pedos. Like, they have the impulse. 85% of men who've had their butt played with once by a woman, all of them turn out to be closets. They probably don't do it, but they have the urge. All of them, bro. You don't know red pill players like I do, bro. If they're a red pill channel and they give dating advice and stuff, and they're telling you that they liked anal and all that, they're always homos. Every time they're, well, you know, when I was 15, this older boy did this to me, John. I'm like, what the fuck? You're red pill, bro. They won't say it on stream, but they all got molested and fucking had their root chakra fucked up. And bro, honestly, I feel bad for you if you got raped, but get the fuck away from me, you fucking rapist. Like, all rapists have been raped. So if someone's been raped, they're about to turn into a rapist. 100%. Right? All abused become their abuser. Like, most of them. So get the fuck away from me, you fucking rapist. Yeah. Yeah, maybe you're not a rapist. I don't want to take chances, bro. I don't want to take chances. Also, if you have thoughts, like where you're attracted to me, what are you doing having those thoughts? Like, what? HS lets his friend watch him as... Bro, stop talking about this fucking shit, bro, because you're running imagery, bro. That's fucking... Stop, bro. This is why I hate comment sections. You guys post like a BBC thinking it's funny on my Discord and shit. I'll delete my whole Discord if I open up one more fucking... funny joke. You think it's a funny joke. It's funny because it's a GIF in your phone that you look at, that you pull out. You look at it. You actually, that's what it is to look at. You look at that stuff. Okay? And the guys who find it extra funny are extra faggot. 100%. Like, and bro, check this out. I've never been around gays, but I don't even hang around potential gays. Like, I'm more afraid of potential gays because the gays just stay away from me. You know what I mean? Why did you act like a pedo? Bro, I've acted like a psychopath, a pedo, a rapist. It's fucking hilarious. It's just not hilarious if you actually are, right? Because that means someone touched you as a kid. You got touched. You got fucking violated, bro. If you've ever been touched as a kid or molested, get the fuck out of my chat. I don't trust you. What the fuck happened to you, you fucking demons love you. Go unravel that, you stupid bitch. I don't care. This channel is not a good Christian channel. I don't want to be around that. This is disgusting. Okay? All accidents that happen to you, I know you feel like you deserve them. You don't deserve them. But you deserve to get the fuck away from me. Get the fuck away from me. Go to God. Get the fuck away from me. Okay? And if you run trains on chicks, get the fuck away from me. I said this for 10 years straight. I haven't changed my position once. Get the fuck away from me. You should burn in hell. You and your buddy ran a train. You huffed and puffed as he did, you fucking faggot. You synchronized your chants. Fucking nasty. Yeah, anyone who runs trains on a chick, first of all, it's kind of sad. Hey, we don't have any bitches, so can we share? Okay. Yeah, this drunk bird right here, she's down for both of us. Oh, there's a cock involved. Okay, I just won't touch it. That makes me straight. Oh, yeah? That makes you straight? Why don't you put a tutu dress on? You know, at least you're piping a chick that's straight, right? Do it in a fucking tutu dress since it's a girl and it's straight, right? Oh, why don't you do that? Because it's gay? Yeah, it's gay because there's a fucking dick in the room, you fucking faggot. Other than that, those people are cool. I'll forgive someone if it happens once and they deeply regret it, but stay the fuck away from me. Bro, none of my friends have gone through weird shit like that. Like, I didn't grow up with, you know, I didn't grow up with any of that shit. That's just weird. His boy penetrates his girl. Like, bro, why are you telling us that? Like, just stop, man. It's sad that bros brag about that. And I don't even think it's the no dad thing. Sometimes I think it's like that Zoomer energy. The Zoomer energy of let's share so we don't have anxiety. If we're alone, we'll have anxiety. Let's share. What lion would ever share their fucking mate? Like, what the fuck? Yeah. Oh, if it was up to me, I would guillotine any deviant sexual practice. Anything, I'll just cut everyone's head off. If I was Napoleon, I would say, what? You like feet? Is that what you like? How about we cut your fucking feet off and kill you in Times Square, you fucking weirdo? Yeah, any dude who likes feet should literally burn in hell forever. Like, a toenail gets you going? What?
Rooster donated $5.
This is a good stream.
Spitting calls even gay jokes piss me off. They're trying to paint a picture.
Yeah. True. Nothing else is funny except BBC.
Justin Powerhammer donated $5. 22 Life Path 7 Day, November 7th, 2002. Scorpio. How do I turn this into money?
You're Gary, but build their version. That is insanely good. Like, wow. You just pick something and build it. You know? You're Myron with a 7. That's insanity, dude. That's such good. Such a good for individual combo. Yeah. You should look in your hidden, too. See what else you got. Because usually if someone has good shit, there's even more good shit. Usually it balances out, actually. But I've noticed that the lucky are a lot more lucky than regular. So yeah. Zirka, do you have 6LP in your circle? No, but I like sixes. When I meet them, I fucking click. Like, bro, a six is like this. Sup, Zirka? And I'm like, yo, what up? And they're like this. And then they stop talking. And it's fucking heaven. Like, thank you for that, bro. And then you meet an 11 and they go, Zirka, you know what? If I did this for you, I can roll. Like, shut the fuck up, bitch. I already hired you, you fucking bitch. Let's see you manifest. Let's see you manifest at a set snail's pace, you fucking bitch. HS humiliated you, bro. Percocet is more of the damage, bro. What are you talking about? HS is, how you say, a man who gets his, what's that called? Rectum? Harrison Sullivan gets his rectum licked by a woman, but he's straight. That Before we even had a problem, I made a clip saying, what the fuck? You know? I gotta let shit go, bro. I, like, really, like... I was calling Ice Poseidon a faggot for, like, 1 year straight. I was like, I think he's a low-key faggot. And, bro, I was right. I'm always right. Anytime I sense it... Yeah. I went to Miami and only Gary and Myron were the straight dudes. Even Fresh throws me off sometimes. I'm like... Because... Fresh is a straight guy, only around women, but he gets so happy to be around his whores that it's gay. So there's like some gayness there. You know what I mean? Whereas Myron and I are kind of grumpy with our whores off camera, and Fresh is more like, gotta go in the box. And I look at Myron like, bro, like, he gotta be hitting that more angry, more straight. And Myron goes like, don't talk about Fresh like that. And I go, bro, what the fuck? Fuck you, Myron. And Myron goes, fuck you. And no, I've never talked to him about any of that. But I have said to Fresh, I'm like, bro, like, you're a black guy smiling ear to ear in a Lambo truck with an F-sized titty whore. And you're saying, Zirka, jump in. You think I want to get it? That looks like a nightmare Miami situation, dude. This looks like we're getting up to no good, bro. This looks like, how do I look in the backseat of F-sized, you know what F are? Like, F-sized fake tits. And he's just smiling, and so Fresh picked me up like 5 times in 1 week. Like, we kept running in this small place, right? And he kept always saying, I'm like, yo, so what's up? Like, why'd you throw me in, right? And like, where are we going? And he's like, I don't know, where are we going? And I'm like, what? Like, Fresh never has somewhere to go. He just drives around until he sees hoes and picks them up. He's fucking effective, though. I've never seen him alone. And he saw me alone like 10 times in a row. And he's like, Zirka, you get all the bitches on my show, but you're alone? I'm like, dude, that Lambo truck is... There's got to be something... He's a 5 life path, so he entertains them, too. He's got that entertainer energy. Or he's a 5 energy or something. Something's magnetic about him. It's definitely not that grill, bro. Because when he smiles at a girl, he smiles like... See, bro, I'm not gonna lie, Fresh smiles at them like he's gonna kidnap them, bro. When I smile at a girl, it's like I'm gonna, like, make fun of her. So it's kind of, like, different. But when he smiles at girls, he's like in the bushes, bro. Yeah. Myron's base, he never smile at the bitch, bro. Right? He just pat them like good. Like a dog. Like fucking... Yeah, I like Myron's energy the best in Miami. Right? Like, what? Remember when HS got mad because they won't red pill platform him? They're like, nah, he's not red pill. He's not going on the show. And I'm like, bro, what the fuck? And he had a mental breakdown. He's like, no, I deserve to be on that platform. And no, bro, you make money with OnlyFans whores. Like, you're not getting on there. But now I'm going to start doing that. I'm opening up an OnlyFans agency, bro. I don't give a fuck anymore. I think I'm going to open up. What's it going to be called, though? I think you and HS would be homies. Yeah, I could see us being homies, but I can also see him telling a girl behind my back that Zirko's a bad guy so he can pipe. He's got, like, Zoomer energy. I would never do that to him, like, ever. Like, even if I hated the guy, I would never stoop to faggotry. You know, like, yeah. Yeah, there's some Zoomer energy I don't like. Like, do you know Myron? Myron would never whisper to a girl, Zirka's a... Bro, but he didn't know me, and girls are like, oh, you know Zirka? Myron would be like, he's a great guy. But on podcasts, he wouldn't say. He didn't know me, so he wouldn't say on podcasts. But, you know, for the hoes, he never pulled me down to, like, win them over and shit. And I repaid Myron, though. I one time called him with this baddie, bro. And I'm like, yo, thanks for the podcast. She's coming over right now. And he's like, no, she's not. And I forced it to happen. And then Myron's kind of like, nah, it doesn't want it to happen. And then after it happened, Myron's just like, okay. He's like, I got him some fine ass shit. Like, this is how I did it, bro. The girl's like, oh, so you're famous? I'm like, yeah, he made me famous. Who? And, whoop, whoop. And I just fucking gave her the FaceTime. And I think he piped within 10 minutes of meeting that bitch, right? Yeah. And I told the girl when I met her again that week, I said, nah, I can't pipe you. And that's like homie rules. And she's like, why? I'm like, because Myron won't put me on the podcast. And she's like, what? I'm like, no, I'm kidding. But I made it sound like he's my boss. And she's like, oh, so that's how it works? I'm like, yeah, I got to go clock in some hours for Myron. And the more I put myself lower, the more she wanted him. She didn't even know who the fuck he was. And I did the whole, you don't know who the fuck Myron is? Bro, you make no money, bro. That's the podcast. That's, you know Joe Rogan? Who the fuck you think put him on? She goes, oh, I've heard of him. Have another shot, bitch. I got shit to tell you. But yeah, people do me good. I always try and repay them like 10 different ways, right? Sneeko, I felt bad for. Because like, when I tried to get Sneeko some birds, it was like the kind of girls that would stab you. But I'm not going to lie, bro. Sneeko's naive, man. Why is Mike still on the screen? What the fuck? You know, Sneeko is kind of naive, like Zoomer Energy too. Not in a bad way, but look at this. Bro, check this out. This is the funniest story I never told. I always remember it, but I never tell it. I always forget. Bro, when I had no clout and I had 20,000 followers on Twitter, right? What the fuck? Sneeko, I guess he's been famous so long he doesn't understand how fame works. So, it was like, it was a year and a half ago. You remember when I was with Sneeko and Arab? So I put on all my fighter notifications for UFC fights. And I'm like, I'm sure Dana's going to get Conor a fight, Khabib. So I put on all my notifications. And I'm like, yo, Sneeko, this chick likes you here. I messaged her and stuff. Me, Arab, you, Yassine, we're going to go out. And I give the phone to Sneeko. And he gets worried that he's reading too many of my DMs. I open one DM, I hand it to him. And then Conor McGregor tweets something and it buzzes. You know how it shows the top? And then he's worried that he's reading my DMs. He goes, yo, Conor messaged you. And I go, who? And he goes, Conor McGregor. And he gets up and goes, gets a glass of water. I thought he was trying to be funny. I grab the phone and I look at him. And he's dead serious. And he had that look in his face like, man, Zirko's got 20,000 follows. Like, how the fuck is he this connected? He had that kind of look like he should be doing more for himself. I mean, he's never jealous or anything, but like, and I remember like, yo, this guy's a fucking retard. Like, I couldn't believe. And I said, for business purposes, I'm not going to tell him that's a noti, right? And then I was like, shit, yeah, I better take this. And I went to the balcony for a cigarette. And then he puts me on fresh and all that. Like, he probably forgot. Like, that's not the reason he did it. But I just let him believe that for like a year. He probably doesn't even remember that. But that's the first time I had a celebrity notification and someone said, yo, you got DM. It actually looked like the fucking, because it was like an emoji he tweeted. So it looked like he messaged me an emoji. And I'm like, yo, Sneeko's been famous so long. He's been around so many famous people that he thinks everyone just like connected, even if they don't have clout. Like, his brain is fried, bro. And yeah. I'm not going to lie, though. It made me really think, like, wow, he grew up with the internet and I grew up with like half-half. Like, I'm old, bro. I grew up a little different. Right? Like, if I got an emoji, I would never, I don't care how many followers Sneeko has, I would never think fucking Connor's hitting up Sneeko with an emoji, laughing, crying face. What the fuck? Yeah. 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 Yeah, that was funny as shit. That happened like a year and a half ago, and I never told that. No, 2 years ago almost. Yeah, 2022. But yeah, I remember the first thing Sneeko said to me. Like, I started pulling some bitches on camera, and he's like, I've never seen that before. And I'm like, what? He's like, you have the worst team around you. There's no way you're not viral. Like, you suck at YouTube. Because you have it. And then that, my confidence was always high, but I was like this. Wow. I think Fresh and Fit is my podcast. Like, I'm about to crack. And he's like, yeah, when I put you on, you're going to crack. And I fucking crack that bitch. Most asked for guest, right? Tate had to get arrested to be asked for, bro. We just took over that bitch. Yeah. Man, I had such a good life, man. Like, shoot me with a bullet right now. What a ride, man. The only part I didn't like is when I was being accused of being CIA all the time. Because that's when I really started doing dumb shit. Like, I was like, if I do dumb shit, they'll never accuse me of being a Fed. Remember that phase? The doxing phase? Yeah. So that ruined a lot of relationships too. I was like frustrated and shit. Yeah. Yeah, what you know what's weird though? I still, this is gonna sound like huge cap, because I, you know, Clout's fun, it's hilarious and shit, but I still like 2022 more than 2023. The Haas streams, you know that phase? When I started reading again, my mind started changing. Damn, those years went by. I still feel like 28 or 27, excuse me, because of COVID. But COVID really hit hard, man. Like, I'll never forgive those lips. They need a burning out. Cause doesn't anyone feel like 2 years has been stolen? I guess this is how the Jews felt in World War II when that never happened. I'm kidding. I'm kidding. This is the worst podcast moment I ever had. With the girl. The girl's like, I hate Hitler. I'm like, me too. Especially when I found out he didn't even do it. Right? He's 6 million short on the receipt. And she freaked out. I was like, I'm kidding, I'm kidding. Like, obviously, he did it. Yeah. But anyways, I can't think of a human who's had a more rich life than me. I had all this, all the jobs you want to have. I had all the bitches you've ever wanted to have. I didn't pipe them like how you guys. I made them bark like dogs. I made it the hot way. I conquered them. I made them cry for me. Well, they cried for me. Like, I did everything I ever wanted to do, and then, fuck it, let's crash out. And I did that, and now I'm here, most money I've ever made, doing fuck all. And, yeah. Yeah. It's a good feeling. Like, if you've been on the journey with me, you know... No one had more fun than me, bro. Like, dog. I'm telling you, bro. Yeah, Yama, I hope your mother gets stabbed with a penis against her will and raped. That's what I hope. Okay, Yama and chat? Fucking faggot. I'm kidding, I'm kidding. Love, love, love. This is a Christian stream. Love, love, love. Yeah. You still got no virgin? Yeah, but they're ugly, bro. Like, one in the chat if you like nice, curvy, wet hoes. Water skin. Their skin like water. Their face like butter, but their body, bro. Butter face, butter body, butter face. Right? Like, one in the chat if you would want to pipe all the chicks that I've had. Like, one in the chat if you would want to be reincarnated as John Zerka. Yo, there's some cap-ass niggas in this chat, bro. I swear to God you guys would want to be reincarnated as me over Andrew Tate because he don't get genuine burning desire from his dream. His dream is Horus. My dream's more chaos. I don't give a fuck about whores. They give a fuck about me. But man, you're jealous of Jack's relationship. McKinley actually loves me because she's like, wow, you don't like me. Like, you're easy to be around. I'm like, yeah, you're not hot. But yeah, I've never been jealous of Jack's relationship. I just thought it was kind of... It raised some questions when he said he never piped. Like, what the fuck? That was weird. Oh, guys, I forgot. Dude, I was going to do a tier list. I've never kissed and told. Like, I keep all these, you know, all my past secret, all that. But I said, fuck it. Fuck those bitches, bro. You know, they're not going to do shit for me. I might do a tier list on the best box I've ever had. And put all their faces and all the receipts and all that. I was thinking no one's ever done that stream because they can't do it. No one can do it.
If you had to start again, amongst all the wisdom you've gained in your life, what's a few things you'd tell yourself that you'd hope would lead you to the knowledge you have now?
I just wish I wasn't alone for most of it. things really started opening up when I got a little social, you know, which is around 26. Alone 20 to 25 is way longer of a feeling than any other age for some reason. Yeah, alone at 28 is different than alone at 22, you know? Like, yeah. Like, not being around friends now is kind of different, but damn, bro, I was talking to my brain, I was talking to my thoughts for so long. Been talking to myself forever, yeah. And how I wish I knew me better. That song hits, bro. Yeah. Because I never realized, even though I didn't cry, I was crying till 25. Just not physically. Like, the inner child inside was like. So, in a way, Raj and them are angels. It's like, you don't consider them friends, but you're spending 5 hours a day on screen with them. You know? What woke you? Well, I swear to God, I'm not saying this for clickbait. I swear to God, look at me when I say this. I prayed on New Year's, and a month, well, the 3 weeks, month later, I don't know, I bought a $300 PC after New Year's because the prayer was to do this YouTube shit. And some dude in the internet just reached out on Omegle and said, come to this show. And I was like, oh, synchronicity. I prayed for this. And then I had that feeling like, I don't want to do it. And then it was so meaningful that I'm like, oh, that's the gate that I kept missing. I kept missing this gate. I never had this gate. Because I never even had a YouTube channel or anything. I didn't try. But I said, oh, that's my now or never. Which was dangerous. If I didn't think it's now or never, I would have just done it more healthy. But I went hard.
Tiki Tiki Taki donated $5. How are you not a spellcaster? Every time I watch your streams at night, I fall off the wagon and get depressed because lack of sleep, which leads to falling off the wagon.
You can fuck off. Like, you don't have to watch this. And plus, you're falling asleep. I'm not even that interesting. Just go to bed. Yeah, I'm just reminiscing. But yeah, God just gave me the gate. And I don't know if you're like me, but I'm the kind of guy that, like, let's say football. I can't play good football unless everyone's a fucking beast. Then I play blood better. But if everyone's shit, I play shit. I do good under pressure. So that stream was fucking
fire. Casey donated $5. Raj John the Patel. First DM'd you 18 times asking for a reading slot, lol. You never respond to me on X sad face. I'm a 33 that got fired from engineering and I need advice.
Bro, I have over $21,000 I haven't read yet. So let me get these guys done first. Like, they're literally, I have their money. Like, that's fucking scammer energy. I gotta read for fucking all day tomorrow.
Margarito Canales donated $5. What do you do to prepare before an interview, show, stream?
The first time ever, I did nothing but I just kept seeing flashes of going back to my old life. And I would have this thing in my head that's like, who cares if you sound corny? Just be real, because if you're real, that guy is so badass. Because I know when I'm, like, if I'm alone with a girlfriend, and we're not entertaining, we're just chilling, you know, I do the same jokes and all that, but then, you know, there's some real moments, they go like this. Oh, that's who you are, John? They give me that look, and I go, man, that is so magnetic. Like, the deeper me, and I'm like, if I can show 1% of that, I'll have a following. Because that's my higher self. I didn't know all this, but that's what I thought. And yeah, that confidence did come from, you know, like, well, bitches love me, so I'm going to pop off. Everyone, if the bitches love me, the chat's got to love me. Chat loves the chat. So that helped. But also, it's like, there comes a time in your life when you get that knock on your heart and the chambers of your heart actually vibrate. They don't pulse. They don't go faster. They kind of just... You get that... Like God is like... And I'm like...
Shoot. Upon him donated $5. Love you, Zerka. I'm a Scorpio horse. Life path 1/07/11/1990. Making music. What should I focus on to bring people to Christ?
Focus on your music. But you're a water sign. You'll do good with music.
Donated $5. Because you're Christian and I believe I'm away till you go to 500 for readings 1 because most won't do it and my broke ass gotta save lol.
Just spam his name in chat. I'll give it to you for like really cheap, but no one else, just you. I'll give it to you for $350 asking. Yeah, what are we talking about? Yeah, basically, the whole message of every stream, but especially this one, is you're gonna make it, dude. Oh, yeah. All you guys think of, I'm not gonna make it. You are gonna make it. Change it to when. If you want to worry about something, worry about when. That's healthier. If you have to worry about something.
Rooster donated $5. No pie, refuse take my money.
What the fuck? Yeah. Yeah. You know how I know you guys will make it? Because the alternative is the life you have right now. You know? Do you know what I'm saying by that? Yeah. By the time you guys are 30 and shit, you're not gonna fuck with that. You're not gonna do this life.
Ola123 donated $5. Capricorn, January 18th, 2004. Sub numbers 1, 9, 6. Life path 7. Wood monkey, tell me some.
It's a lot of info. Yeah. The only time you're never winning is when you're playing games, and your nature is to play games. So you better make games pay you, because I got that trickster energy too, so I make it pay, you know. But that's what I'm pretty much. Here's what I'm saying, dude. If you don't make it in life, guys, your life doesn't change, but you're an older version of this loser self. That's fucking scary, right? You know what I mean? You're gonna be a 45-year-old loser. That's fucking traumatizing, bro. You should laugh. If you laugh at it, it's way healthier. You shouldn't be scared. Fear is the wrong quantum field, man. I'll say this, the devil is a force, it's not a person, and man, does he feed on fear. You know? Yeah. Like you're feeding him. And the devil's cute, right? He sits right here, and I go, ah, you're still tempting me? I'm busy. I'm not mad, I'm busy.
Birth time donated $5. Does the birth time matter? I'm a 33 LP born on the 10th at 11:18 a.m.
Yeah, it matters severely. But you telling me your birth time doesn't pop up where the planets are aligned in my head, you fucking idiot. Right? Always check your identity. Your ascendant first is big, then check your sun, then your moon. Your son is your higher self, right? So you eventually want to become solar, right? You want to become the heat, the warmth in your life. Your moon's like your lower, kind of like bodily wants, emotional. That needs to be checked. And the sun checks it. And then your ascendant is what archetype you're being ruled by. So John Wayne Gacy, I don't know if you guys know him. He's the most Neptunian chart that you could have if you look at. So he's a clown serial killer. Pisces, very Neptunian. That's when you go off the rails and you're ruled by that archetype of the delusion. Delusions of grandeur. Yeah. If you're ruled by Mars, chances are you're moving boxes angry all the time. It's funny because my Mars is located in my talent house, my money house. And it's fully exalted. Chopped
cheese donated $5.
So I got a yell.
Five life path born on 29 day. Any advice coming up on 27 years old this month?
Yeah, you have Conor McGregor's numbers. What did he say? 29 and 5? Yeah, 11, that's 11 and 5. So, that's good. But Conor has Jupiter in his identity, like in his ascendant. That's his identity is money. That's fucking retarded. Like, having it in your 11th house is good, but identity house? That's insanity. But it also expands at a rapid rate where it's going to ruin him too. It grows up.
Five donated $5. LP9, November 27th, 1996.
Fuck all that. You have a 22. Just, that's all you need to hear, bro. That's dominant. That's the best number in the game. If you're a good person, 22 hits harder than anything. I don't give a fuck. 33s dominate history, but nowadays 22s dominate. 22s is, oh, I hire these guys. These guys are diminished. Is 22. Look at this guy. Look what he does in fucking 5 minutes. How the fuck is that a thumbnail, bro? Like, who's teaching this guy? He also did this. This took him a while, but he just gave me this. Like, these guys can build anything. He also gets paid too much money. Diminished literally does 5 minutes of work now. But he was loyal. He deserves it.
Iamrian Price donated $10. Asking for $10 worth of spiz for a life path 11. Birthday number 1. Soul urge 22. Expression number 5. But are expression and soul urge numbers BS?
Yes. They're BS. But you have really good shit. That's a balance.
DadNigga.com Jr. donated $5. How do you smell out the demons and the bitches you're fucking? Or do they just not affect you cause you have such a strong connection with God?
No, they affect me. Like, all my bad days is because I did something stupid. I just don't platform the stupidity that much. Like, there's a lot of stupid shit in my life. Like, if I just cut out women, I think we'd have a mega church in like a week. But I also like learning. I love seeing when my manipulation that I teach works in front of my eyes. Like, I do little experiments. Like, recently I experimented just basically like spiking my charm or charming them, but adding rape jokes, and then 99% of them really enjoyed it. And that experiment, you know, I used to run that experiment on the nighttime girls, but daytime girls love it. And I'm like, huh, this is good to show my chat that when you're like the crush in their head, they'll laugh at anything. And it shows how demonic their nature is too, right? But I don't want you guys doing it. I just want to show you guys the female nature, right? Yeah. Does that make sense? Like, guys, they're dragons. They're not women. Like, let me show you. Okay, Gingy says, deep down, all women crave rape. Let me polish it for you. Deep down, they care about marital. Nah, we're not doing this, bro. Fuck out of here. You see that black chick who posts on Twitter, I don't give a fuck. You can't rape someone in a marriage. A man can't rape a woman. And, bro, literally, I scroll by that tweet. And I was like, phew. I'm trying to tone that down, bro. She wasn't joking, though. The first comment was, I'm not joking. I'm like, holy shit, she doubled down. That was crazy, bro. Who is the hottest woman on earth? Probably Vanessa Hudgens. I posted a tweet. I've never seen it before, but I tweeted about her. And she looked great there. Yeah. She used to be, yeah. Oh, Sama, land this shit, bro.
Batman donated $20. Which version of the Bible is the truth? Tired of deprogramming.
The Catholic version. Also, if you're tired of the Bible, you should stop. I'll only do the Bible when I'm in a good mood or a very dark mood, but I'll never do it when I'm in a little bitchy, feisty mood, because that's how you like resented like homework, and that's dangerous. Okay? You shouldn't be getting bored, first of all. There's something wrong with you if you're getting bored, but it's because of social media. You have like 5 seconds of attention now. Yeah, I don't know. I'll never stop defending it, right? My first time ever inside a church was last year. I went right from my second appearance my first week on the Fresh Fit. And I just walked in there and I was like, wow, this is nice. And then I stopped for a while. Then I went back. Then I stopped for a long time. Then I went back. I always feel weird in there, though. Not gonna lie. I've never felt cozy in there once. Yeah. I always feel like, especially after the popping off, because, bro, I'm not like, you know, people see, like, Bradley Martin or these YouTubers on the street, and they go, what up, Bradley? Bro, when my people see me, they, what? I can't believe it's you. Like, they saw, like, some zoo creature. So I'm like, if I get seen in church, it looks $5. Fucking weird.
Bro. Evangelical Christians are better than Catholics.
It's like a Jew-loving Christian. Yeah, you give your money to Israel, bro. Don't donate here. You're an evangelical. You gotta go do some. You gotta go do some Jewish shit, bro. You trying to go to heaven?
Birth time donated $5. My son is in Gemini, Moon in Leo, Ascendant in Leo, Mercury in Gemini, Mars in Virgo.
Wow, you're an attention whore. That's good that your thinking is done in Leo, but Moon in Leo? It's like what a woman would tell you is good. Your son should have been in Leo.
Anonymous donated $5. Is wishing upon a shooting star satanic? It's kinda a falling star, right? The Disney song even says, when you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are, all your dreams will come true.
Bro. Wish fulfillment happens every day. Like, when you desire something, it's a form of prayer. You're desiring it into your world. So, for example, the most common desiring prayer people do subconsciously without knowing it is, man, I wish she would call me. And then you're putting it out there that she's not calling, so she's not calling, and she'll never call. So that prayer gets answered more than anything. Yeah. God goes on faith, bro. Like, would you have faith in, as in, do you have faith it'll happen, or do you have faith that it's not happening? If you have faith that it's not happening because it's not happening, it's not going to happen. Sounds simple until you have to do it in your own life, and then you go, ooh, I've been thinking wrong my whole life. Yep. True. Ask Goggins will tell you that. Or any winner will tell you that. Even winners fall off. Like Joe Rogan will just smoke weed and he'll forget his winning habits. It's like, bro, you're Joe Rogan. Go back to what made you. Go back to being positive. Stop thinking about, are mushrooms God? Like, what? The fuck are... I've had the vision, and I never used psychedelics for it. I've had multiple visions, like trance-like states. This is the first time in my life I'll ever talk about this in detail, for a little detail. And I'll tell you this, that feeling of knowing, you already have it. You know God is real. That vision, if you're not ready for it, when it gets reinforced in a way where it's fleeting, and then you can really fuck your life up. Because, not trying to recreate the experience, but it's like you don't deserve it. Because, yeah, there'll be a moment in your life where everything clicks. If you're the spiritual type, a lot of science can never have that moment because they just don't have the interest. I'm talking about the Neptunian, 12th house majors, these kind of types. The Pisces, the a lot of water signs, but not with psychedelics and shrooms. I'm saying like the correct way. If you've never received, we're talking about Kabbalah. If you've never received, feel bad for you.
Noxter donated $5. How come you're in relationship a bunch of women hit you up, but when you're single they don't even hit you up? Is it because of the status that you're in a relationship?
No, it's the expanded consciousness of abundance. Like I have a chick that I have is every day when she gives you a morning text, you have, I have, and grow a sense. Oh my God, his quantum field has. I think I like you now, John. But when you're single, they're sensing I don't have, you know, or I want. That's the dangerous one. And they go, ugh, Zerka wants right now. He's not in mating season. You know what I mean? That's why it's good to be surrounded, right? Okay, we got to wrap this up. I like femboys. I don't know, bro. Are you Nova? Are you a chick or a dude? Like, that sounds like gay shit to me. All right, yo, I carried this stream, bro. This is like a 10 out of 10 stream I did. This chat's boring as fuck. I gotta get out of here, bro. I want to stay another hour, but this is the gayest chat I've ever had. Like, what the fuck happened to this community? Like, I'm not going live for another week because of this. Plus, I think I answered everything perfect anyway. So I'm gonna do my own website because that's where we really talk. This shit is gay as fuck. This is like, I've never even had a dead chat. This is the first time I've ever seen that. That was the weirdest. I lean back. You guys lean back. What is this shit, bro? If you're not rolling, I'm not even spizzing, bro. You drained the fuck out of me there, man. Gayest fucking chat. Actual faggots. I've never had that. That looked like, bro, that looked like a weak chat, bro.
Justin Powerhammer donated $5. 12th house Scorpio Sun Mercury and Venus, 1st house Moon Pluto and Rising Sagittarius.
Never mind.
DadNigga.com Jr. donated $5. Do you believe God is the universe or God is outside this world in the heavens above? Or both?
It has to be both if you believe in the Holy Spirit, right? Like, let me tell you this, dude. There's nothing closer than God. Yeah, you'll know it when you go, when you're still, man. You have to be still. Your mind got to be still to feel that.
Burning in hell donated
$5. You guys are chatterboxes, bro.
How can burning in hell be worse than this life? At least in hell there is no hope and the pain is physical. Having heaven and then getting it taken away from you gradually is far more cruel.
Heaven's not taken from you and life cannot die. Only death can die. Do you understand what I'm saying? You cling to life because that's heaven, bro. You want eternal life. That's why you cling to it like a little bitch. Like, the only thing an organism clings to is to be filled by God. That's it. That's why a wild animal even, they'd rather be in the wild where they get fucked up and mangled than in a cage. Because they want to be filled with the spirit of stillness. They're at peace when they can be their animal self. You're not an animal. You're at peace when you could be in God's image, your true self, your higher self, right? From minerals, vegetation, animals to human, What's next? What's in the next plane? The next plane is all mental. Well, mental is the tool. Mental is the all. Okay? Your imagination is everything in this world. No, we're not doing monkey, bro. I'm getting the fuck out of here. I like doing these deeper streams because I'm worried I'm going to get hit by a bus this year. And I want my legacy to be more than monkey.
Jobs donated $5. Is Croatia a good country?
Yeah,
I recently got a job offer for engineering at Bugatti. I'm a 33 LP.
Yo, yeah, what the fuck? Cool.
Burning in Hell donated $5. How does the food chain not terrify you? Have you not noticed that the entire world is a pyramid of consumption? And now the Jews consume us.
Fear consumes you, young Skywalker. Fear is worse than your diet. Fear is worse than a bullet. Fear is... How are you not afraid, Circa? Bro. Stop with the fear shit. But they're like putting chemicals in the banana. Just eat the fucking banana, you stupid faggot. Okay? Your fear is hurting you a lot more. Okay? Your body will run the alchemy of that banana and shit it out. Okay? It'll be transmuted. Don't worry about that. The little metals in your food, that's why people die over time. Even that can be overcome through the mind. Okay? So let me tell you this, bro. I think you guys are like not bulletproof even 365 days of the year. Like, I think you guys have soft brains 365. Like, I have a feeling you guys don't have one day where you feel good. Like, I can sense faggots in this chat. Like, look at this guy. He said, Lean Wright said, I fucking love you, Zerka. How the fuck do you fucking love me? Huh? How the fuck do you fucking love me? I haven't gotten a dollar from you. You don't even have a little subscription sign, you fucking bit. Energy is love. So send some of your fucking sweat labor this way, you stupid fucking faggot of a human.
Rooster donated $10.
What a gay name.
Your streams when you pour wisdom is better than your entertainment ones. Monkey, yeah. I've been watching the
really
older
feel like
on
that
$10
before
broke, you got
fuck,
big and the value
key,
there
kill
is
yourself,
unmatched.
Kill yourself, fuck you, faggot. $10 donation. Think you can yap here, broke ass bitch. Come on, bro. This is the best stream I ever ran. Every time I have a good stream, it's $2 stream. Like, last stream, I literally pulled 7 bands out chat. I would start the fucking Misery Olympics with the fucking fat-ass losers of this chat.
Rooster donated $10. I already said I was broke. Stop spellcasting.
Where are my books? Wait a minute, this is a Mexican's name. Huh? Excuse me? Are we building the wall in this chat? I don't know about this.
Go watch John Zerkin's dead.
Jesus Christ, this guy, man. Enemy UAV
spotted. Margarito Canales donated $88. Zerka, appreciate your advice. You don't need the cash, but here you go.
Oh, really? How do you know my financial situation? Huh? How do you know that? I'm this close to refunding my people. I don't want to do that many calls, bro. I miss streaming. I love Hitler. I'm kidding. That's what got me banned last time. What the fuck is wrong with me, bro? I can't get bored, bro. All right, let's talk about something. Yo, what the fuck? What are we bored, bro? Come on, hit me, bro. I'm having that, bro. I'm killing this stream. Why did I say that? That's a tick, bro. I haven't... I want to have dreams about...
T donated $5. Hi, Zirkle, would you rather watch a tree grow or a Negro?
You know, this, my first exercise for my mentor was watching a plant grow, and it was literally on my vase here for weeks. I barely water it. I never watched it. I just said I would. yeah. Aristotle used to get his students to do that. It's a quieting mind process. It's like really expands your consciousness if you're... You got to be like that lady in the... You know that lady that has a garden and she watches her... Well, the care package in the mail. Not bad.
John Zerka is the best streamer in Twitch.tv.
Who?
John Zerka.
This is a little long, right? We can change this.
All the juicers, listen.
Who was this gambling guy? This guy's awesome, by the way. Come get Mark.
Margarito Canales donated $88. Hey Zerka, I know you're busy with your calls, but can you send me your top audibles, books? Was Hitler evil, as the Jews say?
I don't know. If Cookie Monster had 6 million... Hold on. check this out, dude. I promised my brother I'd solve those jokes. Alright, check this out. I got a video where it's being edited right now. It's a very long video. It's over... 50 books, and I'm gonna edit some out because I'm only doing the books that I've read 10 times each or listened to 10 times each. And yeah, this video is like, if you ever want Zerka content in your head always, but I'm not live, these books get you thinking like me. Like, here's one. I'm doing it in chronological order, so you guys, like, if you guys just do the books your way, it's going to take a while to absorb all that. But if you do it my way, with the easy book, harder, really hard, Steiner, you know, go that way, I think it's best. But this dude right here, I know he didn't like the Jews, and we love them, and we love all people, but this dude is number one, this mustache guy. This is my archetypal, we all have the grand old wizard archetype, right? It's different for other people, and people say, oh, yours is like Albert Pike. No, man, it's... This is the dude, bro. This is the start of it all, man. This is when thinking never hurts your head again. This is step one. This man right here. This is step
Burning one. In Hell donated $5. Saw the video of you ringing some bell in Japan. Why is that the shy, introverted guys like you always turn into the most extreme scumbags yelling faggot later in life.
Because we were saying it when we were gamers, bro. We were just too afraid back then to say it in public. But we were Dragon Knights saying faggot all the time. Now we're Dragon Knights in public, bro.
But look at this, man. I cannot be... To the thinkers, I know a lot of gamers here who don't think, but to the thinkers in chat, this is one of the greatest geniuses that ever lived. Like, Haas used to get me to read Hegel. And, bro, these guys, these commies are fucking... They can't teach you shit, bro. This is where you want to start. This dude is... Everything you've ever wondered, he goes in depth on. And you're going to be like, I thought I only thought of that. This dude is... Carl Gustav Jung. There's also a part where he says Jewish people are weak like women and psychically not on the level of Christians, and no one's on a Christian's level of psychic development. So he's seeing it as a practical thing, the Christianity thing. It's more pragmatic, and then it gets mystical later, but all the writings is practical, and then the later stuff is... Like, he won't give you mysticism without explaining his thinking. So you'll never be like, oh, this seems like some voodoo shit. Like, you'll always be like, oh, yeah, that sounds like a therapist. That's what a therapist would say. That's... Yeah. The one that I'm on right now is where his client starts fapping in front of him, going in a trance state because her dad, like, spanked her once and she started avoiding her dad because she was, like, turned on by it. And he beat the shit out of her brother and she'd get really turned on by that. And he didn't do word association with her. He just triggered her memory in a trance state by making up a lie. He told the story of his dad being like that because he assumed that's what her dad was like. And she had, you know, hypersexuality disorder. What was that called? A very neurotic behavior. And yeah, this is the game changer. If you're into self-development, fuck the red pill, dude. Right, take this pill, and don't do, like, where people go wrong is they go into interpretive works. So Judith Butler explains Carl Jung. No, go to Jung. Don't go to anyone. No middlemen for your thinking. And it's not hard. He writes for everyone. Like, he wanted to help people. And he even dealt with severe psychosis that let him write the most profound shit he's ever written. So he in self-induced psychosis later, very late in his life. That's when his expanse in consciousness was... Yeah, that solidified him as a legend. But I don't know why people talk about any other thinkers. There are no other thinkers. There are no other philosophers. There are no... Right? For what's going on today and what he's predicted... This is your guy, okay? Not the fucking Art of War, not Think and Grow Rich. Oh, wow, some fucking fat liberal librarian bitch read that too. Yeah. And it's awesome because it's like, he's not going to talk to you about your drugs. He's not going to talk to you about your drinking. He's not going to talk to you about your ex-girlfriend. He's going to talk to you about your unconscious and why it needs those things. And that's... when life starts making sense. And it really reflects ancient Egyptian psychology, which is, you know, he revised psychic alchemy. This is the guy, man. Yeah. Very consistent in all of his work with ancient, you know, the geniuses of antiquity. So, what book is that? I showed it 10 times. Memories, Dreams, and Reflections by Jung. It's a good start.